Security, which runs out of money early next year.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
Antiwar.com reports CIA Director John Brennan angrily condemned the release of the summary of the Senate's CIA torture report, saying the report was flawed and incomplete and unfair to the torturers who were not interviewed for the report. The reason no CIA officials were interviewed by the Senate Intelligence Committee for the report? Well, that's because the Justice Department would not allow it, because those torturers might face legal ramifications for all the laws they broke. Even Brennan conceded some of the things they did were abhorrent, but shrugged off the notion of liability for anything, saying there was no easy answer and that it was unknowable if the torture really worked.
Saying that he was giving his co-workers at Marley Publishing just a few more days to catch on to him, local mentally unstable man Michael Redding told reporters he planned on exhibiting one or two more warning signs this week before, quote, finally doing this.
I think I'll do just a couple of disconcerting things in front of people here at the office. Maybe give them a day or two to take action through the appropriate channels. But if that doesn't happen, then I'm going through with it.
The fully unhinged Redding, who plans on, quote, making this thing happen sometime next week, claims that despite displaying erratic and worrisome behavior around the office for the past few months, his actions have gone completely unreported by his coworkers.
I definitely talked about my frustration with life in general, and I even discussed my fascination with all sorts of violence. But that still didn't throw up any red flags. We'll see if anyone catches on.
Mike? I don't know him super well, but he's nice enough. He's quiet and he keeps to himself mostly, but I'm sure he'll come out of the shell. Just a matter of time.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can take control of the airwaves here. It's the live Sunday edition of the program. The toll-free number, as always, 855-450-FREE. That is the toll-free number. Also, you can join us via Skype if you prefer, and I have to say I prefer that because it usually sounds a lot better. Skype username is lrn.fm, and welcome to the show with you tonight. Ian here.
And Mark.
And Mark, you engaged. You yourself, I guess, didn't do the dirty work, but today you watched as Rand Paul, Mitch McConnell, who else?
Harry Reid and Chuck Schumer.
Were all slaughtered. Was it a throat slitting? How was it done?
It was done with a .22 rifle and a big knife. Now, these are the names of my pigs.
Oh, you ruined the surprise. I was going to tease it for like an hour
before
we actually got
No way.
Oh, well, all right, so Mark's pigs are dead. We can talk about that later. FreeRoss.org. We actually haven't mentioned that in a little while here on Free Talk Live. I got an email from Ross Ulbricht's mother, Lynn, who I'm grateful that we had the chance to interview in person at the Porcupine Freedom Festival this year, and I think we're going to be seeing her again at the upcoming New Hampshire Liberty Forum in March. Lynn is the mother of Ross Ulbricht, and Mark, who is Ross Ulbricht?
Ross Ulbricht is supposedly, the government claims, the man who was behind the Silk Road, the Dread Pirate Roberts, as it were. And there's a lot of confusion as to how many Dread Pirate Roberts there were before Ross Ulbricht. If Ross Ulbricht is the Dread Pirate Roberts, if he is, I contend he's a fool for living in San Francisco inside the United States and conducting, you know, the most wanted drug operation in the world. Silk Road is a place where Silk Road 3.0 exists. So there's a place called Silk Road currently, and you can buy and sell the things that you want to buy and sell there. What that means is since there's, you know, you can just sell whatever you want, that means that people are selling things like drugs.
That's right.
And what we've seen is
there were some rules on things you couldn't sell at the old Silk Road. I don't know if the new Silk Road 3.0 still has those rules.
Nor do I. But I can say that there was a study done by a couple of professors, and I couldn't tell you from where. And what they found was is that the Silk Road made the black market safer.
Mm-hmm.
That
oh, yeah.
people were conducting in the business they were going to conduct in anyway, right? Like, Silk Road didn't suddenly create a bunch of drug addicts.
That's true.
What it did was a service that people who wanted drugs would go, and they wouldn't be exposed to bad neighborhoods or people who had weapons right there. And that it made the sellers, the drug dealers, operate on a higher level. Now they had ratings where they, you know, people said, well, this was a good deal or this was a bad deal, and they had to service their customers the way that businesses do in the marketplace. And I think that this, I think it was a real step forward in many ways. But the government can't have this. Oh no, we can't have people doing what they want with their own bodies, having license in their own lives, and we must stop this. And so it looks like they did.
Well, they shut down the first Silk Road, and they arrested Russ Ulbricht, accused him of being the mastermind behind what the Silk Road was. It was only a month later that Silk Road 2.0 popped up. They took Silk Road 2.0 down last month, in the beginning of November, and the alleged guy who was running that, Blake Benthal, supposedly admitted it. Now, there hasn't been a development, by the way, in the Blake Benthal case. I looked the other night. I couldn't find anything new about that. But the Russ Ulbricht case, this is the big one. This is the first time that anyone has ever been busted for an online drug empire kind of charge. You know, they're hitting him with the kingpin statutes, basically treating him as though he were Pablo Escobar. And they are, in fact, acting as though he was Pablo Escobar. They're accusing him of committing, not directly committing murders, but allegedly hiring people to commit murders.
Sounds like a drug kingpin.
On his behalf. However, they're alleging he hired enough people to kill six people. It might have been the same person he hired for multiple people, but anyway.
You'd think if things were going the way you'd wanted to,
apparently put a hit out on six people. That's what they're alleging in this case. But the weird thing is that they haven't charged him with conspiracy to commit murder.
Wait a second. Are you telling me that my public servants have not charged a man that they believe that they have evidence have murdered somebody? They haven't charged him with it?
I've heard that he's been hit with a charge out of Maryland for that, but I haven't followed up on that detail. I'm not sure how to verify that claim. His mother has made it sound like he's not facing charges for murder. He's certainly not facing charges for murder in federal court in Manhattan, where it is he will be facing charges for things like conspiracy to distribute drugs and conspiracy to commit money laundering, conspiracy to commit computer hacking. Those are the charges he received as a result of being involved with the Silk Road. That's what he's preparing his defense for. You can go to freeross.org to contribute to Ross's defense fund, because it's not cheap to hire attorneys to take on federal cases. It's not cheap to hire any attorney, but for a case like this, it's definitely not cheap. And so, you know, he's been going up. Apparently the court case has been delayed. It was originally going to happen like last month or something like that, and it got put off. I think it's coming up in early 2015, I believe in January at some point. I don't have the exact date on when that's going to trial, but there's been a motion filed in the case that his mother emailed me about just the other day, and it was actually, I think, just yesterday, and it's pretty outrageous. And I wanted to share this with you because it's amazing the kind of stuff these guys can get away with. Now, just to be clear, this motion hasn't been approved yet, but as Ross's mother points out, the judge in this case hasn't denied a single request from the government. So every motion that the government agents, the prosecution, has filed so far in this case has been approved. So there's no reason to believe this one's going to be kicked back in their face, but, you know, again, the motion hasn't been ruled on. What they're saying is they want the ability to be able to talk about the alleged murders. The alleged murders for hire in this case. And essentially, I looked, it's a 29-page long motion in limine, and I looked over it the other night. Essentially, their justification for this is that, well, they claim, of course, other court cases where they claim this sort of thing has been allowed for allegations about things that the defendant has not been charged with are allowed to be brought up in court because the government has to tell the story. They want to tell the story of Silk Road and what they allege, Ross's role in the Silk Road.
Well, you need
was
a narrative, but if you're going to, in your narrative, you're going to accuse a man of murder, you need to have charged and convicted him of that first.
Well, you apparently think the old way, Mark. You with your relic ideas about the way the justice system should work. And if you think that's interesting, there's actually a motion that has been approved by the judge. I'll share with you here in a moment. But just the fact that they would just so they're so brazen just to even ask for this. We want to talk about things we haven't bothered. We don't have enough evidence to charge this guy with, because you know if they had enough evidence to charge him with going and hiring a hitman, they sure as hell would have charged him with hiring a hitman.
Six times.
Yeah.
And all of them federal government agents, they would have the emails lined up. I mean, come on.
Yeah. So very strange. So not only that, not only do they want to introduce that information, but they also want to prevent Ross or his attorneys from talking about his political beliefs.
Ross, so they can have their narrative,
but
Ross
can't
have
his. If this motion is approved, again, hasn't been approved yet, but that's what they're asking for next. And that's exactly what this is, Mark. They want to be able to tell the whole story from their perspective, but they want to prevent Ross from being able to tell. Let's say he is Dread Pirate Roberts, and let's say Ross is, you know, wants to go for jury nullification. They actually, jury nullification is where a jury will vote not guilty, and you know, in the with the idea of just kind of batting the law back in the face of the prosecution, essentially saying this law sucks, we're going to vote not guilty, even though you've proven that he is, you know, that he did what you say he did. We think the law is terrible, so voting not guilty. They actually mention in this motion, Mark, that if Ross Ulbricht or his attorneys are allowed to talk about Ross's political viewpoint, which is libertarian. He's a very liberty-minded individual. If they're able to talk about his motivations, so, you know, to make the black market a safer place or whatever it was his motivations were, the politics and the motivations, if they're able to talk about, or they want to prohibit them from being able to talk about them, and they specifically say because it could result in jury nullification. That's their reason why Ross Ulbricht should be prevented from talking about his motivations.
Jury nullification is a thousand-year right in English common law when, you know, juries have the right to say that this law stinks. And they're afraid, you know, the lawyers that run the lawyer industrial complex that rules the world are afraid that you, the individual, may get the power to overturn their rules.
855-450-FREE, even something even more outrageous coming up.
Jack Woolery here. You know, I've talked before about Australian Dream, the effective arthritis pain relief cream that doesn't burn, isn't greasy, and has no odor. Now there's new Australian Dream back pain cream with all those great benefits. But this penetrating formula can help relieve your simple back pain. And it's backed by an empty jar guarantee. If you're not satisfied, you can send back the empty jar for a full refund. But I don't think you will, because Australian Dream really works. Don't let back pain ruin your day. Get Australian Dream back pain cream at Walgreens.
You've heard of Black Friday doorbuster deals. Well, don't miss Lumber Liquidators floorbuster deals. Get incredible discounts on your favorite floors at one-time only prices. There's never been a better time to get a great deal on pre-finished hardwoods, hand-scraped hardwoods, gorgeous bamboo, top quality laminates, and get 26-month special financing. Plus, get even more floorbuster discounts in our stores. The sale ends Tuesday, so these deals will not wait until after the holidays. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book. And it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Free Talk Live.
Now, I can understand why some people would look at what the mainstream environmental movement says and does and advocates and come to the conclusions that, well, some of these people seem to want humans to go back into caves.
They do.
But that's not to say that just because the most vocal environmental activists out there
are socialist nut jobs
are that way means that, well, we should just forget about taking care of the environment.
Who wants pollution?
Who wants any of that stuff?
Right.
What I want is market-based solutions that don't involve threatening violence against people, and that's what the government solution always is. The government doesn't persuade. The government doesn't ask
The government demands. And if you don't go along with their demands, they've got a nice cold concrete cage waiting for you.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you'd like here. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. We're talking Silk Road, the latest in the Ross Ulbricht case. He's facing most of his life, probably the rest of his life, in prison for ostensibly running the Silk Road underground drug black marketplace that has done amazing things for the black market, that has made things safer, has made drugs more reliably what they're advertised to be, brought prices down, raised customer service up. But, you know, no good deed goes unpunished. And so he is, again, facing multiple felony counts. And there's a lot of years in that are floating out above his head at the moment. I don't know what kind of a chance he's going to have, because this judge just keeps granting the prosecution's motions to make just insane rules that prohibit, in this case, well, there's actually a rule that has been granted. There's a proposal that's on the table from the prosecution that will prohibit Ross Ulbricht from talking about his political beliefs and talking about his motivations on stand, and thereby possibly trying to connect with the jury as a human being and, you know, maybe get them to nullify the verdict. They have specifically asked the judge to prevent that, while asking the judge also to allow the prosecution to present a case about hiring hitmen, having Ross allegedly hiring hitmen, which, of course, they never charged him criminally with. So why should they be able to make allegations in a case that doesn't have to do with hiring hitmen about hiring hitmen?
Right.
But Ross's mom thinks that they're going to approve this motion. But I'll tell you what motion did get approved that is even more shocking coming up.
It's cold here in New Hampshire, so I'm going to Acapulco. It's Acapulco for Anarcho-Pulco at the end of February. Jeff Berwick, the dollar vigilante, is billing Acapulco as the new Liberty destination. And I want to see for myself. I figure Anarcho-Pulco is an event that's perfect time to take a look. Speakers will include, of course, Jeff Berwick, who's down there in Acapulco, and Angel Clark, who moved there recently. But Roger Veer will also be there, Cody Wilson, Nima V., Objectivist Girl, Luke Rudkowski. Do I have that name right, Ian?
Pretty much.
Yeah, we met Luke over at the Liberty Forum. Quite an activist.
Yep.
Dana Martin, Ernie Hancock, and many more. What more reason do you need to go to Acapulco in February? This is going to be an awesome event. Hotels are reasonably priced. Tickets are less than $100 if you register by Christmas. There are workshops all week leading up, but the action really heats up at the end of February. It's the 27th. Excuse me, the end of the weekend there. February the 27th through the March the 1st is the sort of the big time for the event. But I'm going to for the homeschooling workshop that's the day before. So I think it's going to be great. Anarchopolco.com. It's the new Liberty destination, anarchopolco.com. You can search on Google as far as the spelling goes, but just I'll say it one more time kind of slow so you can understand it. Anarchopolco.com.
All right, so the toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. We'll tell you one of the more recent decisions that the judge in the Ross Ulbricht Silk Road case has made that is just so shocking. Even I am surprised, and I've seen a lot of court nonsense before. This is bewildering to me. We'll get to that. But first, Tom is in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Tom.
The mayor of New York, Bill de Blasio, made some comments suggesting he wasn't thrilled and delighted after that cop that killed a guy didn't get indicted for killing a guy.
And talking about Eric Garner case?
The chokehold case, yeah. There, where now the police union is asking members to sign this paper saying that the mayor should stay away from their funeral in the event that they get killed in the line of duty. Okay, because they're angry that the mayor is taking the side of a human being instead of taking the side of the cop. Now, the thing is, they should also sign similar papers to members of the New York legislature who are tough on drugs in order to win elections, who know very well that as a result of being tough on drugs, cops are going to go out there and get themselves killed trying to enforce drug laws.
Right, so they're putting the lives of the police on the line so they can get reelected, basically.
And the police, but the police benefit from that, too. There's a lot of police jobs because of the war on drugs, and it's not exactly the most dangerous job in America. It's not even the top 10 most dangerous jobs.
Well, also, they know that, what they're doing is they're buying votes on Election Day with the blood of the cops that are going to make that choice to go get themselves killed trying to enforce drug laws. The only reason anybody should go anywhere near any police funeral is because right outside there's all these hundreds of cops standing at attention that are not wearing helmets, and there's no innocent people interspersed
among them. Tom, you gotta cut it out. Thank you for the call tonight, but I agreed with what he was saying up until the point where he started advocating for, and he doesn't really come right out and ask people to do it, but he suggests that people kill the police, and I think that's a terrible idea. I don't think that is going to work.
I don't think anyone heard it in this circumstance. I mean, basically, you know, it's cops without helmets is all he gets to say. But we've heard it so many times, we know where he's going.
Well, that's basically what he was saying there. I don't know if I let him get all the words out, but
that's what he was saying.
That's what he was saying.
I would agree.
And that's not going to solve a problem. I realize that the police, in this case, they are creating problems. They are making people's lives worse through this insane war on drugs. Ross Ulbricht is just one example.
This is what we're talking about here, the police unions and politicians and everybody else in this circumstance is participating in. It's called rent seeking. Rent seeking is when you use the force of government to sort of change the playing field of the marketplace in order to benefit yourself. And, you know, police want drugs illegal so that they have the ability to hire more police, you know, like the top brass. Mm-hmm. You want more people underneath you. If you're the one guy in a town calls himself, one cop in a town that calls himself the police chief, you're far less important than the police chief of New York City. It's how many people you have under you sort of decides how important you are in this circumstance. So they want more cops. They want the higher pay that comes with the danger of enforcing the war on drugs. They want the excitement that comes with busting people's doors in. There's more than 50,000 drug raids in America.
Is it up to 50 now?
Yep, I looked it up. 50,000 drug raids in America a year. Yes. Many of these go awry, wrong addresses, bad information, whatever. Innocent people are killed, children are killed, but the cops just keep on trudging forward because we must stop the scourge of drugs. The scourge is the war on drugs.
Yeah, for sure.
100 years ago, we shouldn't call it legalization of drugs. We should call it re-legalization of drugs. 100 years ago, you could buy heroin at the drugstore. Were there some people that were addicted?
Children could buy it.
Yep, they could. Sure, there were some people that were addicted, and I wouldn't claim that they weren't. There are people addicted today. The only thing that you have is you've driven up the price, which increases crime, violent crime, against non-drug users. The war on drugs not only is a war on addicted people, it's a war on people like you and me that aren't addicted.
The guys over at Law Enforcement Against Prohibition have said that the numbers, the statistics of people who are addicted to drugs are about the same as what they were back when they were legal.
As a percentage of population.
So, toll-free number 855-450-FREE. We were talking about the Silk Road, the alleged mastermind, Ross Ulbricht. His trial will be starting up in early 2015. The story is from Wired.com on what is the most outrageous thing I've heard thus far in this case. And it's been a series of pretty shocking things.
There was something outrageous that the judge did grant that it's not coming to my mind.
I'm about to tell you about that right now. According to Wired.com, according to Ross Ulbricht's mother, who gave me the heads up on this article, the judge has now refused to let Ross and his attorneys know which witnesses will be testifying against him for fear that he might orchestrate their killing from his jail cell.
He doesn't know the witnesses in his case.
That's correct.
People will testify against him.
We'll talk about how crazy that is. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
Are you getting squeezed by the economic downturn? Hey, you were doing fine. Then, all of a sudden, you're having a tough time paying your family's credit card bills. Maybe you were downsized or even lost a job, but you still owe 10 grand or more in credit card bills. And you just can't afford the minimum payments anymore. We're here to help. We are the Genesis Debt Partners. We know the secrets to negotiate better terms with your creditors. Make a free 10-minute call right now and learn how we can help you get out of debt. 800-981-7590. If you owe 10 grand or more in credit card debt and you want to learn how you can pay less and get out of debt faster, call right now. 800-981-7590. 800-981-7590. Get out of debt now. 800-981-7590.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Sunday edition of the program. You can dial in toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. Bitcoin, if you've got some, you want to send some our way as a thank you for doing Free Talk Live, you can send it to the Bitcoin tip jar. Just go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com. And if you're into Bitcoin or maybe just curious about it, the place to be is going to be downtown Austin, Texas, for the second Texas Bitcoin Conference. This year, it's, or next year, I guess, 2015, it's going to be happening at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin, which is a different location than the very first, and I'm excited about it. It's going to have the best and brightest speakers, the latest exhibitions in Bitcoin, and they'll be hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. Plus, they've invited the entire Texas legislature to show them that so that way they can know that not enacting complicated regulations encourages innovation and job creation. The Texas Bitcoin Conference will prove Bitcoin is a force for good. If you really care about Bitcoin or, again, are just curious, this is the place to be. March 28th and 29th. Also, there will be a kickoff event on the 27th. If you get into town early, you'll want to go to that. TexasBitcoinConference.com. You can go and get your tickets there and save $25 with coupon code FTL. Again, code FTL at TexasBitcoinConference.com, March 28th and 29th. Free Talk Live will be there broadcasting live as we were there last year, or I guess it's still this year. It's still this year for the next 2 weeks. Anyway, look forward to seeing you in Texas at the Texas Bitcoin Conference in March. Let's go to your calls and thoughts coming up. The outrageous story, the details on what's happening with Ross Ulbricht, the man who's accused of running the Silk Road. The judge in that case is preventing a witness list from being shared with the defense.
And it's crazy.
It doesn't get much more of a total bastardization of the so-called justice system process than that. We'll talk more about it. Coming up, your calls come first. James is in Alaska. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, James. James in Alaska. Hey there.
This is Alan from Arkansas.
Wow, I don't know where Alaska came from. I'm sorry about that, Adam.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I may have mispronounced it. Yeah, I just had a question. I was just looking at the big picture of this. You know, you got 450,000 active duty in the military. You got over 2 million in our prison systems. To keep the wheel going of the justice system, you have to put a lot of it has to do with 80% of drug offenders. One of the reasons why they go after, like, the drugs is because they're not making any taxes off of that item. Which mm-hmm. is why you would want to legalize it, one of the reasons you would. And I just wanted to get your opinion on that, you know, as far as if they legalize it, I mean, would this guy be going to jail and be having all these offenses against him?
If they legalize drugs, would Ross Ulbricht be going to jail? Well, I mean, if they legalize drugs tomorrow, Ross Ulbricht will still go to jail unless if he gets convicted, unless he gets a pardon. And if they legalize drugs tomorrow, all the people who are in jail today will stay in jail unless, again, they get released as part of the legalization process. So I think that would be a huge step forward, is to not only legalize or fully decriminalize drugs, but also to pardon all nonviolent, peaceful drug offenders. And while we're at it, let's let the prostitutes and the people convicted of gambling out of jail as well. Everybody who has not actually created a victim in their so-called crime should not be sitting behind bars. But it'll be too little too late if they just legalize drugs tomorrow for Ross Ulbricht, unfortunately. And they're not going to be legalizing drugs anytime soon, unfortunately, as well. So we're going to see more people take the fall for doing what Ross Ulbricht allegedly did, and that is running online drug marketplaces, because as one gets taken down, more get put up, and that's just, you know, that's going to mean more people are going to go down over time for this. But obviously they're willing to take that risk.
Yeah, to keep the lawyers working and the judges working and stuff, they got to keep the wheel going of the justice system, so they use the drugs to do that. And unfortunately, the company, like the alcohol companies, have such a big lobbyist up there keeping the drugs from being legalized. That's one of the things. One of the reasons why they don't legalize the drugs.
You mean the big drug corporations, the manufacturers?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, alcohol manufacturers, you know, they got such a big lobby, they wouldn't want the marijuana to be legal because nobody would buy the alcohol.
No one would buy alcohol. People would buy both if they were both legal. But you're right, the alcohol manufacturers and the pill manufacturers, they are generally against legalization of any kind of drug. And it's really tragic because, as we're finding out, and thank you, by the way, James, or Adam, for the call tonight.
as we're finding out, some of these other drugs that have been illegal for so many decades in this insane war on drugs, like mushrooms or MDMA, we're finding out that these things can have really beneficial effects when taken in under kind of therapeutic parameters for, you know, treating PTSD, for instance. Like, you know, MDMA has been shown to possibly cure PTSD. For people who've tried everything, they then try an MDMA therapy session, and it's like one session, and they're done.
We have read stories like that, and I mean, imagine how invaluable this is. But the government says, we're going to send you off to war and break your mind, and when you come back, we're not going to allow the treatment that has been found to work the best.
Yeah.
Because screw you. Because you are livestock for the state, for the people, human beings. Flesh and blood human beings like you and I, who work in the government, believe that you belong to them. How else could they steal the fruits of your labor in the form of taxes? How else could they pay subsistence wages to people who volunteer for their army and throw their lives away and their minds away and their bodies away for nothing?
Let's continue with your calls and thoughts here. Dave in New Hampshire, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Dave.
Yeah, I wanted to talk a little bit about the New Hampshire Secession organization, nhindependence.org.
Yeah, sure.
It doesn't get talked about enough, but they've done some pretty good stuff. They seem to be hitting on most of the cycles so far. They had a couple of little demonstrations that were very winsome, and they have a nice little website and Facebook page. However, I think... there hasn't been that much activity over the last few months, and I would like more activity.
Yeah, you're talking about the Foundation for New Hampshire Independence. They got formed a couple years ago. They came out with a really great flyer that I went ahead and printed thousands of.
Then handed out a bunch of them at the fair.
I really liked it. Yeah, I've handed them out at multiple locations. We did it most recently on Independence Day. We went to, you know, like the local baseball. They have like a baseball game right before Independence Day. We handed them out there, and some folks handed them out at similar events in the Manchester area. So there is some activism going on in regards to the foundation, but it doesn't have anything to do with the foundation themselves. I don't know what those guys are doing. I don't know if they're having meetings or anything like that. It seems to be more of a think tank than anything else, Dave. I don't know if they actually, you know, are doing much more than just kind of coming up with ideas and tools and, you know, websites and things like that.
Do or do not. There is no think.
Well,
it's a do tank.
I agree with you. I mean, I would love to see more action on the secession front as well. And I've done my best to put it out there. So maybe some other folks can sort of step up on this.
I emailed them two different ways, you know, through their website email and then through Facebook, and I got no response in either case.
Yikes.
Over the last month. I did get some responses before last month, but it's one of those things where there was a period of time where the Free State Project wasn't going anywhere either, and then it caught back fire again, and this will happen, I think, with nhindependence.org.
Mm-hmm.
But it's one of those things where people move, they move from statism to liberty, then they realize that they've got to physically move to New Hampshire. But once you're in New Hampshire, it's possible to focus even more laser-like than just on New Hampshire. Maybe inside New Hampshire we need to be more laser-like on this one issue, because it goes to the heart of all the other issues. It's the root striker. It's not hacking at the branches.
But Dave, for me, I find secession to be a little, I find it to be peripheral. That I find that states, look, if we look at marijuana, half the states in the union now have medical marijuana in the face of the federal government. They've used nullification, which is a system of just telling the government, you know, screw you, we're going to pass our own laws. And that's far more valuable and much more likely to happen. What do you think, why focus on secession when you can focus on nullification?
All right, stand by. I'll let you answer that here in a moment, Dave. More about secession and the shocking, outrageous news from the Ross Ulbricht trial. We'll dig into that. Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Hi, I'm John Rainey, Chief Financial Officer of United Airlines, and I'm honored to be the National Chair for the 2015 March for Babies campaign for the March of Dimes. United is a proud supporter of the March of Dimes mission to improve the health of babies and fight premature birth. We're helping the March of Dimes fund breakthroughs in research and community programs that help more mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Please join us in working together for stronger, healthier babies. Visit marchofdimes.org.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the Sunday edition of the program. We're here live. The toll-free number 855-450-FREE, whether it's Ross Ulbricht and the Silk Road case or Secession. We'll talk about anything you want right here. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
And don't forget to join us online over at freetalklive.com. All the features on the site are free, so enjoy those on us. Again, that's freetalklive.com. And if you like the show and you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then you may shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. You get your shopping taken care of. Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. It is that simple. shop.freetalklive.com. It's Amazon. You know them. You probably shopped there before. And it is the shopping season of the year. Things are getting pretty busy in the stores, as always, this time of year. So why bother with the parking lots and the lines and the waiting and the out-of-stock problems? Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. Go into the Amazon of your choice there. There are different ones that are linked. There's Amazon for the UK, for Canada, and for the United States. Click into the right one for you. Get your shopping taken care of. Feel good about that. You get a great deal. Free Super Saver shipping on a lot of stuff. Amazon Prime if you've got it, of course. And a huge selection. It's the same great Amazon. You're just entering through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a cut. Dave is with us here in New Hampshire. Dave, you are talking about secession, and Mark, you had asked the question, because Dave is saying he wants to see more action on secession. I think he's referring to the fact that many of us moved here as part of the Free State Project, liberty activists coming to New Hampshire to get active in the way that we think is best. And that's one of the issues here, Dave, is you feel like maybe some of the people who've moved here aren't getting active on this issue that you find to be very, very important. Is that right?
Well, it's important because it addresses all the other issues.
Well, I don't know if it addresses all of them, but it's certainly, you know, seceding from the United States could certainly be a big benefit to the economy and the freedom of the people in New Hampshire.
I'm not sure that that's true. I don't know that that's true at all.
Oh, it would be a huge boon, Mark. I mean, if people didn't have to pay income tax, they would have thousands more dollars every year they could spend on their own family, their own business, their own self, their dog, their cat, whatever. I mean, they could do all kinds of stuff.
New Hampshire could do more to disallow an income tax by being part of the union. I understand where you're coming from, but the United States...
What are you talking about?
Okay, hold on. Listen to me. The United States can put tremendous external pressure through the State Department on somebody without going to war. They don't have to roll tanks into New Hampshire and blow your house up first in order to fight a war on New Hampshire. They can do that with, you know, the way they fight wars on every other nation around the world.
So you're fear-mongering. I'm not
fear-mongering. Yeah. I'm talking about the reality. It's not fearful to talk about the reality. Kids, don't play with guns.
Are they doing
you may
that to
shoot
Canada?
Yourself or your friends.
Are they doing that to
Kids,
Canada?
Kids, don't listen
Mexico?
To Ian. Canada didn't secede from the United States last week.
Let's assume fear. Mark is right, and we can't really get around to seceding. It's still very useful to have a strong secessionist movement, to have votes on secession, to have referendums, referendi, however that's pronounced, that sort of thing, because it cools the federal government off. It gets them to back off on other things.
I'd agree with that statement.
So many other places where these secessionist movements fail to get secession, but they get everything else. And so that's why it's important in some ways, even if we couldn't completely secede.
So, but Mark, your question for Dave before we went to the break there was something regarding shouldn't we be pushing for nullification? I don't want to put words in your mouth.
And I think nullification is a practical stance.
And that's you where could the nullify, state says no.
Yeah, you could nullify income tax conceivably. I think it would be very difficult, and I would be interested in the machinations of the political process to do
the
it.
The Supreme Court would likely overturn your nullification.
What difference does it make?
It's branch hacking. The controversial nature of secessionism and independence is what will make it work as a push, because people will get so freaked out about it that they'll attack it. It'll be the free Keene effect, you know, like with the Robin Hooders, where now they're getting, you know, national attention regularly. It's because free Keene is annoying, because some of the Robin Hooders are annoying. That's the reason why that much attention was drawn to it. It's the same thing with secession. People are annoyed by it, so many, many people will talk to it, and it will get national attention. It will put us on the front pages, finally.
Yeah, I agree. I hope that we'll see somebody, one of these liberty reps, propose secession seriously as legislation here, or whatever needs to be proposed. Maybe it needs to be a constitutional amendment. I don't know exactly the legal process that would be necessary to get that conversation started, but I agree with you, Dave, that to start that conversation is very important. Have you considered contacting, because we're here in New Hampshire, the Free State Project is moving thousands of liberty-minded people here, and some of them have already gotten elected to the state legislature. Have you considered reaching out to some of the legislators who are liberty advocates and asking someone to sponsor secession legislation?
I have considered it. I reached out to legislators and had other pieces of legislation submitted, and that brought up ethical questions. I am willing to be part of something like that. I am not willing to instigate a piece of legislation that I don't underwrite. I mean, like, it costs $2,000-$3,000 to kill a piece of legislation, right? It costs taxpayers that money. I'm not willing to shell out $2,000 or $3,000. I'm willing to donate a little bit the process of reimbursing the general fund. But to me, there's an ethical question when you submit a piece of legislation, and I'm worried about slipping too far down the ethical slope, right? I mean, forcing taxpayers to underwrite my good idea.
If you don't want to submit legislation to propose secession, how do you propose to get to secession?
So I do think legislation is a good idea. I'm just saying it needs to be underwritten. It needs to be reimbursed so there's no expense to taxpayers, and I don't have the $3,000 lying around.
You said it's $3,000 just to have a hearing on it?
In 06, it was considered to be $1,500 to kill a piece of legislation to ITL. So
where do those costs come from? Because here in New Hampshire,
the lawyer types have to write up the bill. I know that much.
Well, okay. So my understanding of the process is that a state rep can submit legislation. It's already too late for 2015. But state reps can submit their own legislation. They write it, or they have somebody else that they know write it for them, or somebody else submits it to them and they accept it if they agree with it and they put it forward. You're saying there's costs involved where, like, the state's lawyers get their hands on it or something? I mean, otherwise, the only cost would seem to be that keeping the power on in the state legislative building to allow for the hearings.
Because the lawyer's going to be there anyway. They might as well do something.
Right, the state legislature.
I'm often reluctant to buy that idea that, you know, the state's going to spend that money anyway.
Okay.
I think it puts pressure on them financially, and I'm reluctant to do that. Like I said,
I'm skeptical, Dave. Wait a second. I want to talk about this money thing because I think I'm skeptical of how the numbers are come up with when they say $1,500 or $3,000 to kill a bill. And the reason is that they'll tell you that an inmate in jail costs $40,000, because what they do is they take the amount of inmates that they've got, they divide the cost of the budget of the jail, and they charge each inmate per a dollar amount. And that makes some sense until you realize that if you were to remove one inmate, that the only cost that has changed, I mean, it was the amount of water used and the bologna sandwich he gets three times a day. So the lights are still on, the generators are still running, the officers are still employed. One inmate doesn't actually change the cost of the jail. So I'm wondering here, if this is true in this case of the legislation, is there an actual cost of an additional $3,000 because you put in a piece of legislation, or is that just what the cost of running the apparatus of government is in Concord divided out by the pieces of legislation?
I would be convenient to agree with you, Mark, but I'm skeptical. I think there really is a cost. It just seems
there
reasonable.
Has to be a cost.
But
I'm not claiming there's not
from?
A cost.
Where does the $3,000
right? Because the lawyers that write up these bills, they're paid on salary. They're not getting a per bill pay or a per hour pay.
Well, not every bill's written by a lawyer either.
Yes, they are, because they're written by the state rep, and then they're turned into the lawyer in office there. I can't remember what it's called. Okay. They rewrite it into this is the lie speak of liars that work up there, and then they vote on it in committee, and then they voted on it in the General House.
I didn't know that. Is that true with every piece of legislation?
Every piece of legislation has to go.
Why would they
that?
Let the state's lawyers get a hold of legislation that is written to destroy the state?
Oh,
I mean, that doesn't make sense.
It ruined both of mine. I mean, there were two that I requested, and by the time I saw them and then heard them in hearing, I realized that what I had asked to be submitted would actually grow the government. By the time the general legislative services got done with it, I'm not sure that they were being malicious, but I was appalled by what I had created, and I never wanted to do it again.
Yeah, I can see
like
that.
Like I said, secession is so important but the ends don't justify the means. We have to do it just right, I think.
Well, whatever you can come up with, Dave, I support you on forwarding that issue. Thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Aaron's in Indianapolis. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Aaron.
Oh, hi. I guess this secession thing just kind of got me all fired up, but it sounds like you guys have already given voice to some of my concerns as far as, like, tanks rolling across New Hampshire and things like that. And, I mean, you know, history shows that about 150 years ago, 13 states got together and tried to turn that into a reality. And you
but
know
that's
how
just
that
one history. 100 years ago, there were about 80 countries in the world. Now there's about 200. So history shows that secession is very real and very applicable to our lives.
Well, hang on, Aaron. We can bring you back for further discussion on this. 855-450-FREE-SECESSION.
One failed secession in America and everything's ruined. The country seceded from Great Britain.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture,
furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, December 11th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,231. Silver, around $17.16. And Bitcoin is trading around $360. Today's precious metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by eFoods Direct Storable Food, redefining the way you think about storable food. Learn more at efoodsdirect.com/libertybeat. In the news, a new federal bill introduced by Representative Mike Pompeo would reaffirm that labeling of foods containing genetically modified organisms, or GMOs, is voluntary. Pompeo has the support of the food industry, Democrats, and Republicans. Some Democrats worried that labeling would be misleading, while others worried that the cost of labeling would be passed on to the consumer. Critics of GMO food say they have a right to know what's in their food. Vermont recently became the first state to require labeling. If Pompeo's measure passes, it would override Vermont's law. President Barack Obama recently announced a new initiative designed to help indigenous American youth overcome obstacles such as substance abuse and poverty. The plan was announced at the 6th Annual White House Tribal Nations Conference. At the same time, the White House released the 2014 Native Youth Report, which examines the ways that federal policy has contributed to the struggles of the Native youths. Among indigenous American populations, suicide is the second leading cause of death for those between the ages of 10 and 24. A new study has found that there are an estimated 5.25 trillion pieces of plastic floating in the oceans. Published in the PLOS ONE journal, the study found that plastic is spread throughout the world and weighs around 270,000 tons. The researchers stated the figures were highly conservative and did not take into account plastic that may no longer be afloat. The Liberty Beat is made possible by the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. Support for Liberty Beat also comes from My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at mymagicmud.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, December 11th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Hongkongpolicepublic.com. Hundreds of Hong Kong police officers closed in on the city's main protest site Thursday afternoon to clear streets of pro-democracy demonstrators and terminate the mass civil disobedience movement that has occupied major roads in the South China City for over 10 weeks. Earlier Thursday, bailiffs backed by police to enforce a court injunction met no resistance as they removed protesters' barricades in one part of the protest area. USA Today reports the injunction was brought by a bus company that has complained of disruption to its business operations. Children who are exposed to higher levels of phthalate chemicals in late pregnancy score lower than other children on intelligence tests at age 7. A new study published in the PLOS ONE journal followed 328 New York women in low-income communities from pregnancy until the children were 7 years old. Phthalates are generally found in soaps, nail polish, hairspray, shower curtains, raincoats, car interiors, and dryer sheets. Researchers at London's Imperial College and the University of Glasgow have developed an ingredient that makes food more filling and may help prevent overweight people from gaining more weight. The ingredient contains propionate, which is a natural substance that causes a reduction of hunger. This broadcast of the Liberty Beat is courtesy of Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To inquire further, visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, December 11th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
While digital communications coordinator Brian Tyler is considered by many of his coworkers to be the cutest guy around the offices of Western Psychological Publishing Services, employees conceded today the 27-year-old is not even particularly attractive.
Brian gets a lot of attention from girls around here, but if I saw him in a bar, I don't know if I would even notice him. Put him next to Glenn or Mike, and then, sure, he actually looks pretty good.
Co-workers explained to reporters that by everyday standards, Tyler would at best be considered moderately good-looking, but explained that given the abundance of unattractive men at the publishing firm, female employees often go out of their way to make small talk with the 27-year-old at his desk or eat lunch with him in the office kitchen.
I saw him walking to work the other day, and half the guys on the street were easily better-looking than him. But here, he's the hottest guy around. It's almost kind of sad. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'd still f*** him.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can, of course, join us online at freetalklive.com. Coming up, we'll dig into the details on what was some of the most outrageous news I've heard this year from the Silk Road case. Some of the most outrageous news, period. It's from the Silk Road case. The man, Ross Ulbricht, accused of running the Silk Road, the underground drug black marketplace, has been prevented from knowing who the witnesses are going to be in his trial.
Now, this isn't proposed. This isn't a motion by the defense.
Motion has been approved.
This is a granted motion by the judge.
That's correct.
In the United States of America, a man has been disallowed from knowing who his accusers are before his trial.
Let's talk more about it here in a little bit. Aaron's still waiting to get his thoughts out on secession. We had a caller last hour bring up secession as a topic. And Aaron, you wanted to share your thoughts, so go ahead.
Well, yeah, like I was just trying to say earlier, I think it's a waste of time. There's so many other ways that you can affect change. You guys were talking about like a constitutional amendment or, you know, legislation and stuff like that. But being able to secede from the union, it's just not going to happen.
Well, and, I mean, say never.
I suspect that more likely that the union will fall apart from its own incompetence when it comes to managing money, and that the states will then be left on their own at that point.
Well, that could be. I mean, I'm on you guys' side. Don't get me wrong. I'm just telling you, I think it's a waste of time. And That guy sounds like he was a smart fella, but he should probably be putting his mind to efforts that I think will have better payoff than...
Well, that's the funny thing, right? You guys are, but the guy you're talking about, Dave Ridley, who's an early mover for the Free State Project, he called in the last hour. He was saying that he thinks people should put more effort into the into secession. You're saying he should put efforts into something else. And
that's why
everybody's always got opinions about what other people should do.
But that is the magic of the Free State Project, moving at this point almost 1,700 liberty-loving individuals to the state of New Hampshire. Mm-hmm. And they do whatever they want to do. You know, getting libertarians to do what you want them to do, the whole waste of time thing, and I agree with you. I get where you're coming from. The whole waste of time thing, though, is however the cat-herding hole that we that so many people want to fall into. You know, if all the libertarians would do such and such,
I don't bother
they
myself.
Won't.
Yeah, I don't stress out about what other people aren't doing. I know that there's a lot of people who aren't going to do what I might like to see, so I don't even think about it. I just want to find the people who are willing to do things and who are willing to help me, and I'm willing to help them, and you know, I don't focus on the negative.
But there's some stuff, some activism that you don't think's worth doing, and you don't help those people.
Well, I mean, we all have a limited amount of time,
sure,
right?
Sure.
But I'm not going to bitch at them for it. If somebody thinks
I don't think
that,
anybody's bitching here.
If somebody thinks that I'm not saying Aaron is complaining about it. I'm just saying I won't engage in it because I want to focus on getting things done that I think are important. But, you know, there's a lot of people out there who spend a lot of time critiquing others, and I think those people should probably get to work on something productive, whatever that might happen to be. Aaron, any other thoughts you want to share?
No, I mean, I'm not trying to tell the guy how to live his life. I just think he seemed like a smart guy. I was trying to compliment him. Just, I think he could bear other. But thank you guys for your time.
Thanks, Aaron. I appreciate the call tonight. Yeah, you know, there's a lot of people out there who love the ideas of liberty, and they don't all agree on how best to go about doing it. And they're all welcome here in New Hampshire. If you care about freedom and you want to be around people who are more likely to agree with you on these issues, this is a good place for it. If you put an idea out there, then some people will step up. I mean, if you've got an idea that's semi-decent and you throw it out there like, hey, I'd like to do this. I want to create a TV show or... you know, do this outreach project or, you know, whatever it might be.
Whatever it might be.
There will be people who will say, yeah, it sounds like a good idea. I will come and help you with that. You know, they may not lead the project. That might be up to you. But they're usually willing to help. And, of course, the more people we get here in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project, the wider the pool of potential helpers would possibly be, as well as the wider the pool of the doers, the real instigators, the people who come up with the idea, the people who take the ball and run with it. Those, we need more of those people here. So if you're interested in that, go to freestateproject.org. That's freestateproject.org. Ross Ulbricht's mother, the man accused of running the Silk Road, the underground drug marketplace, Lynn, his mom's name is Lynn. She is a participant in the Free State Project. She joined at the Porcupine Freedom Festival here in 2014. That was over the summer. And I think she said that if Ross manages to somehow get out of this without any significant prison time, which would be a miracle at this point, that he may also be considering moving up to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. So that's very exciting. Ross is from what I understand, I've never talked to the guy, but Ross is a very liberty-minded person. He's somebody who understands libertarianism.
By all evidence.
And now the judge in his case is being asked to prevent Ross from allowing him to prevent Ross from talking about his liberty-minded beliefs to the jury, because the prosecution doesn't want the jury to have a chance of nullifying the case by virtue of Ross convincing them that what he did was the right thing and that what he did was not a wrong thing if he indeed did run the Silk Road, this underground drug marketplace. So that's a motion that's in play right now. It hasn't yet been ruled on. But one motion that has been ruled on is apparently going to prevent Ross Ulbricht from knowing what witnesses will be testifying against him. This story from Wired.com. In a response to a request from prosecutors, New York District Court Judge Catherine Forrest has allowed prosecutors to keep a list of their witnesses in Ulbricht's case secret until January 2nd, the Friday just before his trial begins on the following Monday morning. Her ruling followed a request from prosecutors to redact certain names from the full list to reduce the risk of so-called harm and intimidation. They cited the FBI's account that Ulbricht paid for the murders of six people, including at least one employee who he feared would inform on him to law enforcement. In a letter explaining her decision, the judge wrote that she was, quote, in no position to find that those murder-for-hire allegations are baseless or that witnesses who are known to be preparing to testify against the defendant would not be at risk of some retaliatory act.
So every gangster that's ever been charged with anything in the United States gets a list of his, the biggest dons out there gets a list of his, the people testifying against him, but Russ Ulbricht doesn't? Somehow from...
Not until the weekend before the trial.
Some guy who they have zero evidence can motivate anybody based on anything but money, and they've taken all of his money. Somehow they're going to disallow him. This isn't an organization. He didn't create an organization where there's some kind of fidelity thing. Hey, we got blood here.
He doesn't have
Kiss
soldiers.
The ring. Right. There's none of that going on here. So
nobody even really knew who he was.
He's completely emasculated.
And he's also in a prison cell. And, anybody who's spent any time behind bars knows that communications options are fairly limited and monitored. So it's not like number one, he has soldiers out there waiting on his beck and command.
No.
And then number two, it's not like even if he did have people out there who are willing to do some sort of bidding, it's not like that he's going to be able to send a message out to them in any way that couldn't be intercepted and analyzed by the people at the jail. I mean,
it's true.
It's just absolutely ridiculous. I guess the claim would be that if the lawyer told him in confidence that he might be able to get a message out through the lawyer to send the word, kill that guy.
Well, the lawyer's an officer of the court, and that's the court's business to handle that, right? I mean, you can't trust some guy who went to school for 3 years in graduate school or whatever to get his doctorate in jurisprudence or whatever.
This is so crazy.
It's nuts.
This is not
America anymore. When they can disallow you from having your jury list until your witness list until 3 days before your trial, you have now slipped into America with a K.
I don't know what else to tell you this. You cannot prepare for trial in 3 days. I mean, just finding out 3 days before trial what the witnesses are going to be is just so insane. To disallow this information from coming out is so, I'm so surprised by this because I've been in court so many times, and witness lists are just one of the basic things that's part of the court rules, at least in New Hampshire it is. Maybe not in the federal government. Apparently the rules are pretty different there. But in New Hampshire, if the prosecution doesn't send you a witness list 2 weeks in advance of the trial, you can motion to dismiss that trial, and almost always you're going to have that motion granted. That's how important the witness list is to the whole process of, the justice system is
right.
It's one of the most critical aspects to being able to have a ostensibly fair trial. Now, we know these trials are rigged and they're certainly unfair in so many different ways, but to take away the witness list is one of the most basic elements of putting on a defense, and they've stripped that from this man. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chuck Woolery. After putting a few thousand couples together on Love Connection, you know that nothing kills romance faster than bad breath. Smart Mouth gets at the cause of bad breath without the burn, and you get clean breath for about 12 hours. Other mouthwashes only prevent bad breath for about an hour. Gum and mints, they just cover it up. Use Smart Mouth in the morning for great breath all day. Rinse in the evening for clean, kissable breath all night. You can even wake up without morning breath. Smart Mouth. For 12 hours of real clean breath, look for the green box at your favorite store.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms.
I get it.
You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30%, while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should, too. Find out what they know. Call us, and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We invite you to take control of the airwaves here toll-free at 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have over there waiting for you. Once again, that is freetalklive.com.
You know, I can't wait to listen to In Freedom's Cause again. My family and I are getting ready to take a road trip, and I'm going to bring it with me. It's a two-CD set, and it is an incredible piece of audio. It's, you know, it takes, a couple of hours to listen to it. Mm-hmm. It is basically a movie that's been put on CD. There's no video, but it's the audio is it's Hollywood level. It's got big name actors like Joanne Froggatt from Downton Abbey, James Cosmo from Braveheart, Billy Boyd from Lord of the Rings, Skandar Keynes from Chronicles of Narnia. It has its own score that was produced for it. Just go take a listen to the narration that goes on. It's incredible. Go to infreedomscause.com and just take a listen to the website. It's a great website. Once you are sold, like I am, on getting this, because I think it's a great gift. It's a great gift for anybody on your Christmas list because it's got the message of liberty sort of built into it. It's the story of William Wallace and Robert the Bruce, one of the greatest stories in the struggle for freedom in human history. And I think it's awesome. It's well produced and people are going to be enthralled. My son was, certainly. He really loved it. And I think that it's great for kids. It's it's wholesome family entertainment. And it has a message behind it at the same time. I'm calling it the Liberty Gift of the Season. And we have a special offer for Free Talk Live listeners. You use coupon code FTL when you buy the Family 4-Pack of CDs. That's four gifts. and you can get it with half off. It's $50. That's $12.50 a gift. It's great, and kids and adults alike will love it. It's something you can pop right in the CD player in your car and listen, and everybody's going to get educated. It's historically accurate. It's got some fictional characters that's sort of based around, but you will get the history of what happened, and it's amazing. Go to infreedomscause.com, coupon code FTL to get half off on the family four-pack. Infreedomscause.com, coupon code FTL.
All right, so our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Just shared with you a moment ago, if you're just tuning in, the shocking news. And it's pretty hard to shock me with court decisions. But this one's pretty shocking. From the judge in the Ross Ulbricht case, this lady, according to Ross's mother, Lynn, this judge has granted all of the motions for the prosecution, pretty much any ridiculous thing they ask for, they've been granted. And now probably the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard in a court trial is that they're preventing Ross and his attorneys from knowing who the witnesses are against Ross, who the prosecution witness list will not be available to them until the Friday before the trial, the Friday before the Monday, meaning that trial's on Monday, that Friday, that's when they get the witness list. That's okay, ready? Go! Start your trial preparation.
Yeah.
Figure out who these witnesses are. Where are they coming from? What might they know?
Investigate.
Let's write some
them.
Questions down. Right. I mean, right. How are you supposed to do this?
Perry Mason could not try this case. This
so frustrating.
Is an obvious. What this is, and I've said it on air before, and it's really sad. The fact is that trial level courts in America are completely compromised. They're a worthless bunch of bullcrap. They are part of. They're just kangaroo courts anymore, and that's what is on display right here. The only justice you get any longer is in appeals courts, but it's going to take years. And he's going to sit in prison for those years to get that appellate case. And then who knows what – just because this situation where you have the witness list is rectified in an appellate court and this judge
right.
who, you know, is an obvious government sycophant that's bucking
stooge.
For some – a stooge bucking for a higher position gets scolded years later when no one cares. You know, I mean, it's just the government using the system to screw you. I'm sorry, the America you thought you had is gone. It is destroyed. If it ever existed, it is in the mists of history. Now, I don't know, this once great nation that I was told about in history class no longer exists. It is supposed to be the judicial branch that is the foundation of this government that we have. It is supposed to be what protects our rights, and here it is. It's over.
These prosecutors are the fact that they can get this done really just shows the deck is totally stacked against Ross Ulbricht from the word go. It's really shocking. His defense attorneys had, of course, objected to the prosecution's request to keep the witness list secret, arguing it would be very difficult for his defense to be put on. They noted that Ulbricht.
This is laughably stupid, Your Honor. Yeah. I can't believe you're entertaining this for a second. Yeah. If you approve this, Your Honor, you would obviously be some kind of communist sympathizer, a plant. I can't believe this has been even uttered by an American, Your Honor. I think we should remove the citizenship of the prosecutor in this case. I mean, this is insane.
This
what I'm
is,
hearing.
Right. I mean, part of the idea of being able to put on a defense is to know who it is that's going to be against you. I mean, this is basic constitutional rights. Pull up your constitution and take a look at it. You have a right to be able to confront the witnesses against you. I guess the constitution doesn't say that you have a right to know 2 weeks in advance, so they'll get to confront the witnesses when they're put on trial, but they won't know in advance who they actually are with any sort of meaningful ability to actually ask them questions in court. Having, you know, look, if it's before a trial, that weekend before trial, that attorney's going over final prep. The attorney's looking over his notes to make sure that he's got everything in order.
You can't investigate one of these witnesses.
Right.
You can't find out what these people's motives are. You can't do anything.
So they say that Ulbricht has been jailed without email and has extremely limited access to the outside world. But
I love how these people just imagine that somehow that these hackers, they get in the computers and I don't know what they do, but it's dangerous.
Forrest, the judge, wrote in her response that despite his imprisonment, Ulbricht might nonetheless reach contacts who could threaten the witnesses. Quote, this is what she said, while defendant has limited access to the outside world, that has been true of many defendants in cases who have creatively managed around such limitations. So because in some instances, some defendants may have actually utilized some sort of outside contacts to try to silence a witness or kill a witness off.
It's better that
like
10
that.
Guilty men go free than for one innocent man to be convicted. This woman
nice.
Does not deserve to sit on the bench. I'm sorry that this ruling, in my opinion, she deserves to be jailed. And because this is, I consider this to be on the level of treason. A 10-year sentence in prison is, as far as I'm concerned, what this woman deserves.
Ulbricht's defense lawyer, Joshua Dreidel, declined to comment on the judge's decision. According to Wire.com, the—
This is insane! The judge is obviously out of her mind.
Yeah.
Clearly has not been taking her medication, or is on some kind of government CIA pay— I don't know what I'm seeing here. It's nuts! I'll speak for him.
The accusations of murder for hire in Ulbricht's case have become a controversial albatross around the 30-year-old defendant's neck. Despite describing how Ulbricht allegedly attempted to pay for the murders of six people in pretrial documents, prosecutors haven't actually charged Ulbricht with those murders. Nor have they produced any evidence that anyone was actually killed. He has, however, been charged with attempting to pay for the killing of his alleged Silk Road employee, Curtis Clark Green, in a separate case in Maryland. That was
so
the Maryland
he has
case.
Been charged.
That was the Maryland case I was talking about. The hitman to whom he allegedly paid $80,000.
They need to convict him of that if they're going to bring that up.
Was an undercover DEA agent. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. And why is that case separate in Maryland? What's the deal with that? More on the way, and why is there only one of them when they're alleging that he orchestrated six of them? More on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts, fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Shortly after members of the New York Police Department found a super sharp Buck brand pocket knife earlier this morning, Lieutenant Joseph Mattioli spoke to Onion reporters at the scene of the discovery to update the public on this potentially deadly blade.
At 8:40 a.m., police discovered what seems to be a pretty badass Buck knife. Investigators believe it to be basically the deadliest knife ever.
Mattioli confirmed that the pretty cool wood-handled knife has a clean edge and added that the blade must be, quote, at least like 8 inches long.
At this time, we'd like everyone to be aware that there's probably a man out there with an eye patch and scars all over his face that has access to these knives, or maybe even a samurai sword. We urge people to be careful when approaching him because he may flip out and chop both your arms off before you even realize it.
Following the announcement, Mattioli asked people to come forward if they had any information about the owner of the knife or if they just wanted to hold it for a couple of seconds. For more on this story, check this week's Onion Review.
This is the Onion News Network.
Thanks to Bitcoin, LRN.FM is able to provide our free-to-air satellite channel across North and Central America. You can listen to LRN.FM 24/7 via satellite for no monthly cost. Learn more about our satellite channel at sat.lrn.fm. And if you'd like to help us continue to expand, you can send us Bitcoins via the address you'll find under the Bitcoin graphic in the right column of LRN.FM. To learn more about Bitcoin, visit weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls about whatever you want to discuss. The live Sunday night edition of the program with you here. It's Ian.
And Mark.
855-450-FREE. That is the toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. You can comment regarding the insane news out of the Ross Ulbricht case, Silk Road. He's alleged to be the operator of the original Silk Road, the infamous underground drug marketplace, now on its third iteration. Silk Road 3.0 is now out there. And there's, of course, other online drug markets as well. So stopping the first Silk Road did not stop the second one, did not stop the third one, and all of the other competitors. So they haven't done anything to stop the flow of drugs from buyer to seller.
Arresting Miller Lite, the producers of Miller, is not going to stop the production of beer.
It didn't stop it during Prohibition, and drug prohibition is the new prohibition, and of course that hasn't prevented drugs from flowing all around the world. So Ross Ulbricht facing probably the rest of his life in prison here, and he is now not going to be able to even put on a decent defense because the defense attorneys and Ross himself have been prohibited by the judge from seeing the prosecution's witness list. That's how insane things have gotten in the federal courts. At least here in New Hampshire, you can still have a witness list. But I guess maybe if there were certain exigent circumstances, they'd pull that too.
I'm just amazed.
That's the excuse that they're using here is that, well, Ross Ulbricht may decide to have these witnesses offed or threatened, and so therefore we need to not let him know or his attorneys know who they are.
Right. If they can prevent you from having one person from having a witness list, they can prevent anybody. At this point, they could just say whatever they want. They've charged him in Maryland with a murder for hire situation, and they haven't proven that case. So at this point, they can charge anybody with anything because all they have to do is charge you. And apparently a grand jury, you don't see too many situations where grand juries refuses to convict. Mm-hmm. So they can charge you with anything and then use that information in the trial to convict you and to prevent you from having a witness list. Talk about your lawyer walking in with one hand tied behind his back.
No kidding. These attorneys probably aren't used to having to prosecute cases. A lot of times, they charge people with crimes and then they get a plea deal and the case never actually goes to trial. I wonder when the last time, these attorneys, they're federal
attorneys. The prosecutors,
attorneys.
You mean?
Yeah, the federal prosecutors.
These prosecutors probably are scared to death of taking this to trial. Yeah. This is why they don't want a level playing field. They're petrified.
Right, they're afraid of jury nullification. They've just put another motion in asking the judge to prevent Ross Ulbricht and his attorneys from talking about Ross's political beliefs. They don't want to try. They don't want the jury to be swayed toward jury nullification. And if the prosecution's already objecting to jury nullification, it should be very interesting what happens when activists show up at the trial and start
to talk
firing,
about jury nullification,
and
right?
Start flyering for jury nullification because I sure as hell hope that happens. I expect that is going to happen. It would definitely happen if the trial were happening here in New Hampshire. So, by the way, if you care about online privacy and whatever it is you're doing online, you should care about it. Even if you don't think you're doing something illegal, you should still care about your online privacy because you might just have your information sold by your internet service provider. You never know what they're going to do with that info. Maybe turn it over to the government. Maybe you're downloading some music or movies on a torrent, and you think that's no big deal. Everybody does it. but it's illegal, and there's a very real possibility your ISP will snitch you out over that.
Very real.
So what do you do to protect yourself? Well, you go and get ProXPN, and you can do that by going to proxpn.com/FTL. Get started for free. They've got software you download for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices as well. Linux users, setup's a little different, but it's actually pretty simple to get rolling there. And once you start with ProXPN, your internet is encrypted. Your connection, the data leaving your computer and the data coming in is encrypted and decrypted by ProXPN software. So therefore, your ISP can no longer snoop on you. They can't log the information that you're entering. They can't know which website you're going to, etc. It's very useful. I mentioned torrenting. Well, if you get the premium account with ProXPN, you can privately torrent with that, which is an amazing deal, by the way, considering the price you pay for ProXPN. Just that alone is worth it. I've seen some of these private torrenting services, and they cost more than ProXPN. But not only do you get private torrenting, you get unlimited bandwidth. You get servers around the world that you can connect to. So, for instance, if you plan on torrenting, connect to the Netherlands server. The Netherlands has the best privacy protections of all this, the different countries out there, from what I understand. There's also the ability to get around regionally blocked websites. And ProXPN, by the way, doesn't keep records of your online habits. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. All you have to do is use code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live and the number 50 to save 50% off of the price of the annual account. And that savings is good for the lifetime of the account. So again, go to proxpn.com/FTL, code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. So, according to the story over at Wired.com, Ross Ulbricht, the man accused of being the Dread Pirate Roberts, the operator of the first Silk Road, he is now not going to have any idea who the witnesses are against him until the weekend before the trial, the weekend before the Monday trial, which apparently is coming up in January. I guess January 2nd is the day they will be giving him the witness list. And so it'll be the following Monday, which is the 5th. January 5th is when the trial is slated to begin. And I imagine they will want to start that trial on time, and there will not be any postponements due to the supposed fear that Ross Ulbricht is somehow going to orchestrate the murder of his associates, or the somehow silencing of them from his jail cell. When Ulbricht was first arrested in October of last year, according to Wired.com, prosecutors' claims of his violent acts quickly eroded his popular support among Silk Road's thousands of users and much of the libertarian community.
Well, it erode his, you know, the very fact that they've charged him with this erodes it for me too. Absolutely. If he did that,
innocent until proven guilty.
Agreed. If he did that, I'm very upset with it. But the government here is really doing things. It's very suspicious to me. The fact that they charged the man in Maryland, which I have no evidence that he was in Maryland, so they choose to charge him in a state case in a murder for hire that crossed state lines. The federal government chose not to do that, and they're going to run his kingpin trial before the murder trial, and then use the information that he's been charged with the murder in the trial to sway the jury, which obviously will sway the jury. It would sway me. If you're going to use that information, you need to convict him for it first. You know, they should have the evidence. They're claiming that it was done through a federal FBI agent or U.S. Marshal or whatever. I mean, it should be open and shut. So let's get him convicted. Then we know what the deal is, rather than sort of running his drug trial, which I would support him on if he made the black market a safer place, but I would not support him if he did it while, you know, attempting murder. So let's do this in the right order.
It's sad how many libertarians who should know better than to believe the claims of the state at face value, just take them right as they're giving them, to believe the claims of the state that this man was involved in murders for hire. When I first heard those claims, I found them to be shocking and unbelievable. It seemed to me like they were trying to paint this man as someone he was not. Now, maybe he is a cold-blooded, you know, kind of person, and nobody really knows the truth about him. That's certainly a possibility. But, you know, I don't believe what the government says, and people should get that. They should make that a habit. Like, you should just don't believe them. They're liars. They lie about all kinds of stuff. They have incentives to lie, and it's legal for them to lie. And you shouldn't believe what the government says. Don't let what they say about somebody taint your viewpoint on them and or on that person. And I just think it's sad because people who should know better allowed themselves to be tainted. You said you would if you were on the jury.
Well, I would be tainted if I knew that this was true. That this is the problem here is what the state has done, what the federal government has done in this case for me is caused me to suspect them of lying. Mm-hmm. The way they have this set up. They are not acting like a people like people that are telling the truth. They are acting like a bunch of liars. You don't charge the man with murder, then use that information in his trial for as a drug kingpin before you've convicted him on it. It doesn't make any sense because it looks convenient. Yeah. It's like taking me to trial for a parking ticket and saying that that I was carrying a gun on my hip illegally. That has really nothing to do with it, but charge me with that before you use the information.
All right, more coming up here in moments. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
Convict me before you use the information. I'm sorry.
We've got more on the way. You can take control of the airwaves. Plus, the Sitting on the Face protest going on in the UK. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
The human body is extraordinary. Despite all the stresses we inflict upon it, it still works hard to stay in balance. Thousands upon thousands of people rely upon Heart and Body Extract to help their body stay balanced. This excellent 100% natural herbal formula helps maintain healthy blood pressure levels, cleans arteries, promotes good circulation, balances cholesterol, and more. HB Extract, paired with healthy lifestyle choices like good nutrition and exercise, can give you a life free of pain, sickness, and fear. Recapture your youthful vitality and experience your body healing itself with the aid of HB Extract. It's extremely effective and it starts working in just days. Visit HBExtract.com to learn more and to read scores of testimonials from satisfied customers. And we've never increased our price in over 10 years. That makes Heart and Body Extract as great a value now as it was the first day we sold it. A healthy heart is a happy heart. Call 866-295-5305 or go to HBExtract.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited here to take control of the airwaves. This live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. With you tonight in studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Still to come here. We talked about, teased it last night. Never really told you about it. The face-sitting protest. I've never heard of such a thing before, but it's happened in the United Kingdom, and there are pictures to prove it. We'll share that with you here in a little bit. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We have Skype as well. Send a Skype request to lrn.fm. It'll be approved, and then once you do that, then you can easily call us on Skype. You'll usually sound a lot better if you do it that way. So again, 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number, and Skype username is lrn.fm. Mark, you did some slaughtering today.
Yep.
Not you, I guess. You didn't actually do the killing, but you killed Rand Paul and Mitch McConnell and
Harry Reid,
some other
and
scumbag
Harry Reid and Chuck Schumer. No, they're not scumbag politicians. These are my beloved pigs. I got them back in.
That's good. I'm glad you didn't actually kill anybody.
Yeah, they were born around the beginning of May, and I got them at the end of May, and four weeks old. And I named them all after politicians. And I would call them. I'd say, senators, it's time for your morning meal. And I'd give them a.
Did you feed them donuts or something?
They would get a donut every day. Every pig gets a donut every day.
Wow.
That's the policy out at Edgewood Farms.
Where'd you get your donuts? At a grocery store?
A friend of mine who's a liberty activist has a food route, and he, manages to get organic vegetables. Just what he gets is organic vegetables, and a lot of the stuff thrown away by these froofy places. I got these Spanish tapas things that were completely organic in their own little foil wrappers, and it's just amazing some of the stuff I'll get. And then I get like stale, week old white bread or whatever.
Donuts. Okay.
Yeah, those kind of things. And gotcha. The pigs seem to like donuts just fine if they're a week old.
So you've been raising these pigs, and you've been talking about how it is that you think it's really important to be very kind to animals that you're planning on slaughtering eventually.
Well, I started pigs about this is my third year, and I got them because we were going to put a garden in, and I figured, it'd be nice to till up the soil a little bit, and I got some stumps here. I'd heard that pigs dig stumps up. Do not believe this. Pigs do not Well, over time they will dig up stumps, and by that I mean years. They will make it. They will dig around stumps. Pigs aren't just going to find your stumps and go after them like little bulldozers.
You also probably don't want to let them loose in your garden either, right?
No, this was making the land ready for them. So,
I see.
They're really great to take new land and turn it into something that you can do something with.
All right.
And so I put this little spot back in the garden, and I had the boys, which were two pigs that I got, and they were really a lot of fun with the family. So the next year I got eight, and I decided that was Congress, by the way, was the name of that group.
And weren't you disappointed in that second batch because they were kind of scrawny or something?
Yeah, I got a bunch of runts, essentially, and they just never grew. My biggest pig ended up about 185 pounds, and that's a runt.
What's typical for a pig? What is typical? Well, like 250? Three?
That's basically the range that I shoot for. Okay. And this is my contention. If there's a God, and if he's a he, and if he intends us to eat meat, my postulate taking those givens is that pigs are the meat you're supposed to eat. The reason is in 7.5 months, these pigs went from 0 pounds or, popped out at whatever, 2 or 3 pounds that they come out of mama to 285 pounds was what Rand Paul was. Now, Rand Paul was the spotted one. He's different than Mitch McConnell and Harry Reid, but it's only skin deep. And that's my Rand Paul joke. Anyway, they're all good pigs. I think Chuck Schumer was the best pig of them all. Mm. He was a really good boy. And I go in daily. I would go into their cage. They get back scratches. They get their donuts. And, they come around. They chew on your boots. And they, kind of shove into you. They'd let me sit on them and, for little pig rides. And the battle pig. Yes.
You could actually put your full weight on a pig
and
they'll ride you around?
No, they wouldn't go anywhere.
Okay.
And I have to sort of, you know, I'm scratching them at the same time, but I'm sitting on the pigs. I've got, you know, pictures on my Facebook page.
Huh.
And yeah, sure. I mean, you know, these are pets, essentially.
Big. Okay.
And I raise them with the intention of, you know, being loving towards these animals. And it's not terribly expensive. You can get a spring pig for somewhere between $50 and $125, depending on where you are and you know who you're buying.
Is a spring pig a breed of pig?
No, a spring pig is when you get a pig. And
oh, okay.
Pigs, it's 3 months, 3 weeks, and 3 days for gestation period. You can basically put one pig two batches per year is what a mama can produce.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why you know. They call it spring pigs and fall pigs.
Okay.
A fall pig you would take and put in the barn in New Hampshire and would raise it in there because it's cold and you want it in a better place. The pigs can be in the snow. They kind of huddle up and that sort of thing. But they need to have a little shelter. They should have a little shelter and you know, some hay to lay on, that sort of thing. Pigs love hay. And so, go ahead.
I was going to say, so today was the big day, right?
Yeah.
Today was execution day.
Well, yeah. So the die was cast for this long ago when we get, you know, shortly after you get them and get them sort of acclimated to the area, you nut them is what it's called. And you remove the testicles from the animal. It's just done.
Were they all males? All the pigs are males?
Well, I thought I had a John McCain, but it turned out to be a Kelly Ayotte.
Uh-huh.
And so what we decided, Kelly, you know, I said Chuck Schumer was a good boy. Kelly is a really pleasant animal. So we decided that we were going to have her bred. Unfortunately, we were pig sitting for the farmer that I got her from, some other pigs. And so Kelly, although a very kind animal, seems to have a propensity towards incest. And we found her humping her brother. And she actually tore into the cage where he was, you know, I had separated him. And sure enough, like,
can't keep those two apart.
Yeah,
huh?
You can't stop love.
Mm.
And so we decided to keep her. Turns out she did get bred. So we will have some. By her brother, yes.
Oh, my.
If it's intentional, you call it line breeding. If it's not intentional, you call it inbreeding. So anyway, we're gonna rewrite history and call it line breeding. They were good animals. So what that does is that sort of cements good traits into the pig. This is how you kind of take.
But isn't there a problem with inbreeding? Like, you know, there's some sort of health issues with that?
Inbreeding isn't good over the long term, but in the short term,
generation down generation.
Yeah, in the short term, it's not a terrible thing.
Okay.
You know, the idea is that you take whatever traits that you like about the animal, you're cementing them in. This is how they created breeds of dogs and that sort of thing. Is that, oh, I like this aspect or that trait or whatever. Mm-hmm. And that's how they sort of cement that. And you can do it by breeding, you know, directly father, daughter, you know, that sort of thing, mother, son, you know, or whatever it is you want to do. Anyway, this was accidental, but I don't think it's going to be that big of a deal. And
it wasn't an accident for them.
And what are you going to do? Pay for a pig abortion?
I would think not.
No. Yeah, no. I mean, the veterinarian that I called out because Mitch McConnell had this umbilicus hernia, the veterinarian says, like, I never see pigs because they only live 8 months and or less. Mm. So nobody ever calls a vet for them. And I'm like, okay, I just wanted to see. He wasn't growing. And
so hold on. So this female pig got pregnant.
Yeah.
How long does it take a pig to have babies?
3 months, 3 weeks, 3 days. So it'll be January 20th about.
Okay.
And but the farmer that I'm working with, she's going to take care of her until April when I'm ready to take pigs on. And then I'll take some of her pigs to just hold them. Because all you have to do essentially is feed them. Pigs take care of themselves.
Huh, okay.
And really, it's very little gear. You get an electric fence charger and some wire and some stakes, and you can have your own pig pen for $100. And you can raise your food. What I really love about this, and I love a lot of things about raising pigs, is that my son is completely understands where food comes from. He gets that the bacon that he's eating is from the belly of one of the animals that he was helping to take care of the year before. And I think that this is, I don't think that can be diminished in its value. America has, in my opinion, softened. I don't believe you deserve to eat meat if you are not willing and able to go and do what it takes to create meat.
That's ridiculous.
Okay. That you can have that opinion. But, you know, to me, I just don't think you have what it takes to eat meat. So That's
I got
that.
A knife and fork, buddy.
Right.
That's all I need.
Your meat comes from styrofoam. I get it. That's fine. You can live that way. I choose not to do that. Yeah. And every bite of every meal I eat does not come from my farm by any stretch. We don't produce that much. But we have a large garden, and we have...
It's like saying that you don't deserve to eat vegetables if you don't garden on your own.
You should be able to grow some stuff and look at it and understand where it came from. That's all I'm suggesting. Mm-hmm. It's better than sitting around watching TV. You know, you're going to spend your time on something in life. Yeah. You might as well spend it on something of value that's an education. Yeah. And also...
That's your value.
Consider that nearly every chicken and nearly every pig sold in America are tortured. These animals mm-hmm. live in terrible conditions. The eggs that you eat come from animals that sit in little compartments.
But they have the free range. That's pretty big now, isn't it?
Yeah, they do. Are you
saying that that's still torture?
I would not contend the free range is torture, no.
So then there are some farms out there that are not torturing.
I said
them, right?
Nearly every okay. animal that you eat. And the vast majority of people are eating things that come from animals that lived in boxes in the dark and die without ever really lived.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. You bring up anything here on Free Talk Live. More coming up. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
You've heard of Black Friday doorbuster deals. Well, don't miss Lumber Liquidators Floorbuster Deals. Get incredible discounts on your favorite floors at one-time-only prices. There's never been a better time to get a great deal on pre-finished hardwoods, hand-scraped hardwoods, gorgeous bamboo, top-quality laminates, and get 26-month special financing. Plus, get even more floorbuster discounts in our stores. The sale ends Tuesday. These deals will not wait until after the holidays. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, December 12th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.07 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $352. Antiwar.com reports the Syrian civil war has gotten so convoluted and created so many rival factions that sometimes it's hard to know who is fighting against whom at any given time. It also gives rise to conspiracy theories. One of those theories is that the Islamic State and the Assad government are secretly in league, since the two largest factions in Syria rarely clash directly and rather focus on the smaller players. It's not as though they never fight, of course. Syria launched high-profile attacks on the Islamic State's capital of Raqqa earlier this month, and the Islamic State is still bragging about the recent capture of a Syrian airbase in the Raqqa province. And while other rebels grouse about the comparatively little help from the Islamic State against Assad, it was really those rebels who started attacking the Islamic State in the spring, and the Islamic State has turned the tables on them, expanding their territory at the expense of the other rebels. For their part, the Islamic State is presenting the direct fight against against Assad as step two, saying they need to consolidate the rebel territories first before they can make a serious run on Assad territory. Similarly, the Assad government is seeing the smaller rebels as easy pickings, with the U.S. airstrikes and internal rebel fightings keeping the Islamic State mostly at bay. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, just hours before a potential government shutdown, the U.S. House of Representatives on Thursday passed a massive $1.1 trillion government spending bill. The funding bill passed with a vote of 219 to 206 with a majority of support from Republicans. Things were in doubt earlier in the day after the House took an unexpected recess around 2 o'clock for 7 hours due to dissent on both sides of the aisle. Many Republicans were incensed that the proposed spending does not include language to defund President Obama's executive action on immigration. Democrats opposed amendments to Wall Street reform language in the bill. Though lawmakers in the House came to an agreement late Thursday, the bill still had to pass the Senate before midnight to avoid a government shutdown. The Senate approved a two-day extension of the current funding levels in order to give itself more time to review and vote on the legislation. In the House, 162 Republicans voted in favor of the bill, 67 rejected it. 57 Democrats supported, while 139 opposed. The spending bill, if signed into law, would fund the government through September, with the exception of the Department of Homeland Security, which runs out of money early next year.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com.
Antiwar.com reports, CIA Director John Brennan angrily condemned the release of the summary of the Senate's CIA torture report, saying the report was flawed and incomplete and unfair to the torturers who were not interviewed for the report. The reason no CIA officials were interviewed by the Senate Intelligence Committee for the report? Well, that's because the Justice Department would not allow it, because those torturers might face legal ramifications for all the laws they broke. Even Brennan conceded some of the things they did were abhorrent, but shrugged off the notion of liability for anything, saying there was no easy answer and that it was unknowable if the torture really worked or not. FPP Radio will be taking a short hiatus while I spend the next 3 days in jail for refusing to pay a fine after being found guilty of a residency charge and operating a vehicle with expired registration. FPP Radio News will return on Tuesday, December 16th. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
I was doing my regular 11 o'clock security sweep around the perimeter of my house when I noticed a couple of young people having intercourse in the front seat of a car out in the street. So I ran inside and I grabbed my video camera. As you can imagine, I stood in those bushes for over 20 minutes watching these two degenerates grind against each other, and I'm thinking, this behavior is simply unacceptable. Now, if you think this is an isolated incident, you are dead to rights wrong. I have 36 hours of footage to prove it that I have personally collected from sickos just around my own town. For example, I saw perverts having sex in swimming pools, clearly visible from the roofs of adjacent buildings, on boats that anybody could see with a telescope, at night on the beaches where they can easily be watched by anyone hiding behind a fence wearing their night vision goggles. It's simply disgusting.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. You take control toll free here. In this live Sunday edition of the program, we are live 7 days a week, as a matter of fact. With you tonight, it's Ian
and Mark.
Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com to enjoy the features that you will find there. Lots of different stuff. You get to create the content that's there on the front page. Everything listed on that front page, those numbered items, those are placed there by listeners like you and then voted upon by listeners like you. You vote up what you like, down if you don't like something, or you can just not vote at all. It's up to you. Freetalklive.com. Go there. Get interactive. We got archives galore and so much more on that site, so please enjoy it. It's totally free. Again, freetalklive.com. For those of you just tuning in, we have been talking about Mark's pigs. He has been doing pigs for 3 years. He's had these batches of them, one per year. And you went from 2 pigs in the first year to 8 pigs in the second year and down to how many this year, Mark? I didn't catch that before.
Basically, the answer to that is 5, but I did 4 today.
Because one turned out to be a female and you let her go.
Right. I call them the senators, and John McCain turned out to be Kelly Ayotte.
And today was the day, death day for the pigs. They were killed, slaughtered, whatever you want to call it. And we can get
went to heaven is the terminology that we use at my house.
We can get into that here on exactly, you know, what happened, because this was your first time doing that on the property, from what I understand. The previous years, you had sent the pigs away to some sort of processor.
That's correct. I took them to the place called the Hippie Slaughterhouse. It's down in Athol, Mass. Mm-hmm. I call it the Hippie Slaughterhouse. It was designed by this woman, Temple Garand, who has autism. Her claim is that she thinks like an animal. I'm somewhat dubious of this claim, but who the hell am I to make assertions? She claims that she can think like an animal, and therefore she designs slaughterhouses in a way that keeps them calm. What I didn't like about it, and I like this place, I don't want to make it seem like I don't like this place, I love that place and all the great service I got, they keep the animals for about 24 hours or a period of time before they do it. So my animals are there the last day of their life, mixed in with other animals, fighting and scrapping and pushing around and all that stuff.
And then they die.
And then they die. And I don't want that. Mm. What I want is if somebody's going to kill me for slaughter, I would like it to be done at my house where I'm comfortable and where, I really don't know what's going on, and just bam, instead of all this hustling into trailers and all that other stuff. By the way,
you did have to hustle them into something, though, didn't you?
No.
You just killed them right there in their pen?
Yep.
Oh, wow. Okay.
The guy came out with a 22 rifle, 22 longs in it, and he's standing there with a rifle in one hand and a big sharp knife in the other.
Wow.
And, he would get the pig to come up and it'd sort of nuzzle on the front of the gun. He'd tilt it in. So it's basically the barrel's pointing directly towards the flat part of the forehead of the pig, just off of the center line of the between the hemispheres of the brain.
Okay.
And shoot it like that. They drop like a bag of potatoes. Hmm. It's just amazing to watch them hit the ground. They're dead. He says they're dead before they hit the ground, and they seem to suffer in no way. He immediately goes in and cuts their throat so they bleed out right where they are. It's a gross process, but standing there, I have to believe, like, okay.
Where was your son during all this?
He went to the Children's Museum today.
Okay.
And
so it was just you. The wife took your son.
Yeah, my wife didn't want to see it. Mm-hmm. Jack seems mildly interested in the process, but this is what daddy does. Sort of that thing.
We can talk more about it here in a moment. Alma has a question. She's in Tallahassee. Alma, you're on Free Talk Live.
Sweetie. Yeah, I wanted to ask Mark, because my daddy had a small farm on the side. He raised pigs. He loved his pigs.
Yeah.
We would only kill one at a time, because that's a lot of meat.
Yep.
Does he salt it down, or what does he do with all that meat?
I put it in the freezer, Alma. So I've got 4 pigs, they're at market weight, just like your daddy probably did them. If you're feeding a family, you're going to bring them up to about 275. Pigs mostly.
Oh, yeah, they were big pigs.
Yeah, pigs mostly today that hammers and baconers, porkers or baconers is what they call them. And they're not going to get up that big. Going back into human history, pigs are basically raised to market weight by families that were, rich enough to own a pig and wanted to use that meat to take them through the winter. They would do that. But now it's all about feed and production and efficiency and all that stuff. I don't raise my pigs that way. I freeze them. I take 2 for myself. One of the pigs went to the guy who helped feed me. Get me the feed.
That way it pays for, you're paying for the meat out to help.
Yep.
Get help.
I give him meat in order to get the feed, and then the fourth one goes to Jason Osborne, who is a great sponsor of this show. If a man says he wants a pig, then I raise a pig for him. So.
Oh, that's nice.
I know that was a lot of meat. Did you have to ever clean the stuff out for the crummy chitlins? The intestines?
We didn't have any use for it. We took the intestines, put them in a box, and we're going to dig a hole.
That is disgusting.
Yeah, I agree with you. We are keeping the organ meat, the heart, the liver, the kidneys. What we don't consume, we will give to the dog.
Wow.
I never eat any of that, but I know I came home and they were cooking chitlins after I was grown, and you know I'd visit them every day, check on them, and they were cooking chitlins, and I said I'm going to taste that because nothing can taste worse than it smells. I said, yes, it can. It definitely can taste worse.
Hey,
but I appreciate it.
Thanks, Alma, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Chitlins, they're the intestines, huh?
Yeah, so I understand, yes. Huh, I have never eaten them.
I had heard about the chitlins before, but I never really knew anything about it. I saw some sort of video about, I don't know if it was dog intestine, but I think it was dog intestine. They were eating the intestines of a dog in South China, I think in a Vice.com video,
mm-hmm.
and just thought, wow, that seems a little dirty. I mean, are you supposed to rinse it out first?
I'm sure it's getting rinsed. You've eaten intestines,
yeah,
because you've had sausage. The casing from sausage is intestines.
Yeah.
So you've had it. It's just, you know, the experience and having it just that. It's not so great. If you go to the Vietnamese restaurant and have the tripe soup, you're going to be like, ah, yeah.
There's chitlins in that?
Well, I mean, it's tripe. I mean, it's intestine, yeah.
Okay. I don't know what tripe means. Is it another
Indeed.
Word for intestine?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's presentation that mm-hmm. really matters with it. I wouldn't want to eat only that, but you have eaten it at meals, and you've liked it,
yeah.
and that's that. So I've got.
I'm not saying I wouldn't like it. I would just have concerns for the sanitary factor.
Yeah. By the way, yesterday for people, a lot of people are asking. Sort of, I've got some questions here about what's it like emotionally to raise your animals like
and
pets,
kill them?
And then kill them. And I've got to say, like, this is not delightful for me.
You haven't done the deed yet, though. You just watched.
It would be foolish, in my opinion, for me to. It would be illegal for me to handle that rifle, because that.
Oh,
that's
right.
And why would you? If you have an expert who's there,
mm-hmm.
You know, I pulled the pigs. When he put the willow tree on it, on the pigs. I pulled that pig up into position so that we could hoist it up and gut it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was there doing everything with it. But, you know, you have a person who's going to make the pig not suffer, and you or me. I'm not going to go
and screw it up.
Yeah, yeah, I do not want to do that. The whole purpose of me doing it on the farm is so that the animal is stressed less, because happy animals are delicious animals. Stress hormones really matter. Most animals in the United States that you're getting from the grocery store lived in a state of low-level torture, maybe even high-level torture, medium-level torture, where they're housed in the dark and they never get out and they never get to root around or do whatever it is that mm-hmm. they do. Different types of animals do different things. You won't find chickens rooting. But, you know, it's disgusting with the way they're treated, in my opinion. And so, you know, to me, I'm trying to do a good thing by these animals, and when we're talking about their death, yeah, I'm trying to do a good thing by their death too. I want them to be, taken out as quickly as possible.
Let's go to the phones. Todd's also in Tallahassee, listening to WVFT. Hey, Todd.
Hey guys, how are you?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I actually grew up on a small farm myself, about 100 miles west of Tallahassee, a small place called Chipley, and we raised our own chickens. Pork and cattle. Chickens went first because they're kind of a pain in the butt.
Yep.
But the meat that we got, I mean, my grandfather taught me from a very young age the same kind of respect that he's obviously learned for those animals. And if you treat those animals with love and kindness all the way up until their death as humanely as possible, you can tell the difference.
Yeah,
you can tell the difference in the meat.
I miss that food.
I contend you can.
Hold on. Todd, I'm going to bring you back here in a moment. He's saying you can tell the difference. Mark is saying you can tell the difference. Has there actually been a double-blind study?
Right.
I
don't know if it's psychologically, if it's psychological or if it's real world, but I believe you can.
I want to see that. I want to see that study. I want to see a taste test between bacon pulled from pigs that were in a terrible conditions and bacon pulled from your pigs, Mark. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love, and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you want right here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. We're talking about the killings of Rand Paul, Mitch McConnell, Harry Reid, and Chuck Schumer, a.k.a. Mark's pigs. They were killed this morning.
The senators.
They were killed this morning by a gunshot to the head, and that killed them, and then they were further butchered from that point forward.
Yeah, with
a knife.
Yeah, my assertion is that they are dead before they hit the ground. From what I saw.
So we'll continue the discussion here. You may have thoughts you'd like to share, questions, 855-450-FREE. I know, Mark, you received a few questions through digital means.
Quite a few, yep.
We can share some of those, 855-450-3733. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. We'll continue in a moment.
If you're anything like me and you're watching movies or reading books and you believe in the ideas of liberty, you could be sort of put off by the statist and collectivist notions that are in this pieces of entertainment. Not so with In Freedom's Cause. In Freedom's Cause is a 2-CD set of audio theater, unlike you've ever heard before. This is top level, Hollywood level audio theater. Not that Hollywood makes audio theater, but this is it's such a unique product. There's no movie to this movie. The movie is played on the inside of your mind. There's top level actors in this. James Cosmo from Braveheart. Billy Boyd from Lord of the Rings, Joanne Keynes from, Joanne Froggatt from Downton Abbey, Skandar Keynes from Chronicles of Narnia. And this, when they, they perform to the original score in Freedom's Cause, you're transported. This is the story of William Wallace and Robert the Bruce, and it's one of the greatest liberty stories in history. Really teaches many lessons. The liberty messages are throughout this piece of wholesome entertainment. It's good for kids. It's good for adults. My wife and my son and I all listened at the same time. We loved the story. It was really great. And, you know, you can listen as a family and sit around and listen. And what we did is we had an activity while we were doing it. We were working on something in the house. We were putting some caulk into the floor cracks. And this was great because we could listen and talk about it and work at the same time. And you can listen over and over again. It's really great. Jack loved it. InFreedomsCause.com. You can get the family four-pack. Get four of these gifts for four of the people in your life. I think it's great for kids this Christmas. For half price, use coupon code FTL to get the family four-pack at half price. That's $50. That's $12.50 for four gifts, and you can give them out to everybody you know. You'll love it. InFreedomsCause.com, coupon code FTL.
All right, toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We have Todd on the line listening in Tallahassee. Todd, you had asked a question about how it feels from Mark's perspective as raising these pigs over a period of what amounts to at least half a year. You got them in May, I think you said, Mark. It's now mid-December as we're doing this episode of the show. So, you get to know these pigs over time. What was it like to take their lives? Was that kind of your question, Todd? I don't want to put words in your mouth.
I was just going to, he was talking about his son and being around that. That's what made me want to call. I remember being in the kitchen when I was really small, about 4 or 5 years old, with the women who were doing the preparations inside, as all the men, my uncles, my grandfather, my dad, were all outside, and I was trapped inside. And I didn't like that as a little boy. I wanted to be outside with them, and it wasn't until I was six when I got my first skinning knife and I was allowed to go out and taught, how to do these things. That's kind of my transition to manhood, and I look back on those times, and of course, I'm working every day at a job, and my God, I wish I'd have stayed there. But, I want to say one thing about the meat tasting different. Another thing that I think made ours taste different, we raised all our own grain. We fed them corn that we grew ourselves, and I think, the love went into that, too. And I think, the old farmers that really, we mostly ate what we raised. We sold a little corn, but it was mostly just to sustain us. I think those people back then, more than the corporate farms now especially, they respect the land. They respect, my grandpa was a God-fearing man. I'm not myself, but, I do believe the universe will provide for you in the same way that they believe God will. So I think all that love goes into it, and it does come out, and it does taste better. And, I hate to go to the grocery store now and buy these hormone-pumped-up, water-filled chickens. It's terrible.
I agree with you. And I I'm certain my bacon's better, and I'm sure my regular pork's better too. But I have people tell me all the time. Now, am I getting confirmation bias going on here? I don't know the answer to that, but I think it's special.
I have some photographs. I wish I could send you some photographs. I just made some bacon with my friend in Virginia, and it was and we smoked it ourselves. It was, oh my goodness, God. It was, some of my favorite pictures on my Facebook page are of bacon, man.
Thanks, Todd, for your call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. You too. And the toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Maybe it was somebody else's question that I, maybe it wasn't Todd.
That was one of Chris's. She IM'd it in. And
well, the question was, how do you feel taking the life of the pigs?
Well,
after?
Taking the life of the pig is, when it comes down to that, I don't like the to
was
go
that
out.
The question though was it?
Yeah, yes, it is. I don't revel in going and killing these animals. Mm-hmm. I don't look at it that way. I joke about the senators and all that stuff, and that's all fun and games. But to me, each one of these animals is special, and I approach their life and their death with the respect of what they're going to do for me and my family, which is to provide mm-hmm. food. I can tell you,
sounds like what the Native Americans might have done. That's what before.
I think that's what you're meant to believe. I have no idea what Native Americans.
Some
did.
Of them probably
yeah.
did.
I have no clue. I approach it from that standpoint. There's no violence used on my farm. Well, there was one time when last year when Huey attempted to mount me for the third time while mm-hmm. I was trying to fix the fence that I finally hit him with the pliers and he did go away. Mm-hmm. But
shouldn't be raping.
Well, yeah, I mean, there was in my opinion, that pig had finally violated the non-aggression principle, and it hurt. When he finally jumped on me full force.
That's a big kid. It's a lot of weight.
He wasn't full grown, but yes, it was still. I mean, it's bigger than a dog.
Chris is with us in Arkansas. Chris, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, I was gonna say that happy animals are indeed tasty animals.
I believe
this
so.
This is something I believe people have known for a while, but I first read an article on it about 10 years ago where fish farmers were attempting to reduce stress of the tuna in the water so that the tuna would taste better.
Yeah, I mean, stress hormones are real. No one's going to argue with that. And I wonder what it's like for these animals that live in these factory farms, especially chickens and pigs. Beef in this country is treated a little better, and I don't feel quite as bad about buying that in the store. But we get our chickens from somebody down the street who does it. Actually, the guy who provides me with the pig feed. And we get the we raise our own pork, and you can substitute pork for so much. I have pork burgers. We do our spaghetti with pork. It's better, and this is what I'm recommending is that families that have a little bit of land. Yeah, try a pig or two. By the way, you should get two. They're gregarious animals. They like to hang out with each other. And the competition for food makes them grow faster.
Chris, any other thoughts you want to share?
Oh, no, thank you. That's all I wanted to say.
Yeah. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So,
smelly. People want to know whether or not having a pig pen is smelly. And there's food in there the pigs choose not to eat. Sometimes that can rot. Obviously, poop smells. If you have enough room, mm-hmm. my pigs have more than an acre for four pigs. It's an incredible amount of space, and I'm going to grow it again this year because I like pigs to frolic. On Edgewood Farms, our pigs frolic. And so it's not so smelly there because there's so much area, but it can be stinky by the trough.
855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live. Bring up whatever you want.
This holiday season, give the gift that keeps on giving, an in-home freeze dryer from Harvest Right. With your very own freeze dryer, you'll be able to freeze dry the food your family loves. Because we live in uncertain, difficult times, what better way to show your love for your family than to buy them a gift that helps them preserve food they can use now or in 25 years? Go to HarvestRight.com and find out how you can get your in-home freeze dryer. Layaway is available. That's HarvestRight.com.
How many good people procrastinate? When was the last time you updated your last will and testament, your living will, and your health care power of attorney? If you could get these documents included with your Legal Shield membership for no additional charge, wouldn't it just make sense to have the peace of mind of owning a Legal Shield membership? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world.
So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free. The live Sunday edition continues here. Of course, time for you with your calls and thoughts. You may bring up anything that you'd like. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And you can join us via Skype, by the way. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Mark, how can someone get a pound of some of the best coffee available for free?
Yeah, a pound of the best, most sustainably, most environmentally conscious coffee you're going to be able to find out there. Shade-grown coffee is better for the environment because they don't cut down all the trees wherever they're growing it. In many of these places, the trees get cut down, the coffee plants get put up. You're talking about erosion. The topsoil goes into the ground. The people that surround the area after a decade or two of growing coffee can't grow coffee anymore, and they're just sort of left trying to figure out what to do with their lives after their topsoil's washed away. Not so with shade grown. Plus, shade grown's better for the songbirds that may go from North America down to South America or wherever. And this is important to a lot of people. It's important to me. It's 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica beans. And Buzzbox, with whom we work at coffee.freetalklive.com, they give us some of the proceeds back so that we can give micro loans to people around the world. I think this is a great project. I love it. You'll love the coffee. Upgrade your coffee experience. Start with a free pound of coffee at coffee.freetalklive.com. Sign up for the subscription. You can cancel it anytime. You pay for the shipping. They'll give you the pound. We know you want to try it out, so try it out. And then if you continue, we'll be able to help people around the world with your proceeds. coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, 855 450 free. We continue here. Mark is explaining to us the ins and outs of
small-time pig rearing,
raising pigs for the purposes of ultimately killing them and using their meat and bacon and stuff like that. So there's some more questions that were delivered digitally, and I can share some of those here in a moment. But James is on the line with us here. James is in Arizona via Skype. Go ahead, James.
Hey.
Hey, speaking of the slaughterhouse of four pigs, with funny sounding names, it reminds me of the dirty old man fantasizing of helmetless cops. Hey, but glad to hear life is good outside the pen, Minister Edge.
Go ahead.
Can I ask you a question? I should still like to respond to your utter nonsense about your peddling this U.S. government, State Department controls the world. And
I really believe that. Yeah, sir. By the carrot and the stick, they offer foreign governments money to do what they want, and if they don't do what they want, they'll offer they'll come back with sanctions, and at some point, war.
Right. May I speak Free Talk Live for a minute?
Yeah,
in response to that?
Sure.
You don't have to ask. Just go for it.
Because I don't believe that the U.S. State Department controls the world jury. I mean, pulls the strings all around our planet any more than I believe that the U.S.
What is this jury thing?
That was a joke. It was an analogy.
All right.
There's a guy that actually was really popular that peddled that some other fantastical organization of people controlled the world. The entire planet, and ruined everything for their country. And then until he came to save them, and they really did dig him so much they all saluted him everywhere he went.
They salute
years.
The president of the United States too.
Oh, that's called a sick and despicable analogy. But I should like to continue with my.
This is what governments do, though, James. Governments attempt through foreign relations to control the actions of other nations. The United States is inarguably an incredibly powerful. That's the reason they use the term superpower. Government.
I never would argue with you for that. That's why the New Hampshire is never going to be invaded by the Ruskies for oil. And that's why the U.S.
Probably because there's no oil here.
We've
got tree sap and rocks.
What is the argument you're making anyway?
In response to the U.S. and British empires responsible for millions of people living east of Israel, Ian, that are diehard true believers, by the way, in a very real world Vice News rallying cry that Allah is God, Muhammad is his messenger, death to the infidels. So I'd like to ask Mark about some Stone Age Romeos that really do think that the KKK to Southwest Asia is really cool, and that's why there's no peace in the Middle East. Not because the American government or the State Department propping up totalitarian theocratic governments all over the planet east of Israel that rule millions of people in the
totalitarian governments have always bred extremists. Those are the only people that have the gumption to stand up.
For that. I'm blaming something called true believers in really.
That's what they want you to blame, James. They want you to blame the extremists. But the fact is that the people that were ruled by the Ottoman Empire have never had an opportunity to rule themselves because of the United States government and because of the British government, because Winston Churchill, who you love so much.
Wait. You're blaming the existence of a thousand-year Reich called the Ottoman Empire on the U.S. government and the British Empire?
No, I'm not blaming the Ottoman Empire on them. I'm blaming the fact that they used the fall of the Ottoman Empire to carve up the Middle East.
Yes, you are, because the U.S. and had no involvement in the Middle East until after 1945. And by the way, everywhere the U.S. actually does control, like New Hampshire, you have a show called Free Talk Live. I dare you to go on the airs anywhere east of Israel.
I absolutely agree with you. We have the right to complain in this country. That's absolutely true.
Speaking of a slaughterhouse, you and Ian and all those dope den dwellers of your friends would be dead in the morning if you go on Free Talk Live anywhere east of Israel. And you keep
We're
on
Free Talk Live east of Israel. We have people call from the Middle East. We have people from our Facebook page.
You know what he's saying, though. He's saying if you were producing
the show
there.
I understand what he's saying. There are people people around the world that would love to kill me.
What's your
and
point?
James, too.
Right, what's your point in bringing that up, James? Are we supposed to be grateful to our masters for allowing us to complain?
Military and your fellow Americans that love this country and want peace on this planet, because that's how God planned it. But it ain't going to happen in the
God
Middle
didn't
East
plan
long.
The United States of America, or even mention it in the Bible.
Thanks for the call. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here.
just don't understand.
Look, I do appreciate being in a place where I can, you know, have a relative semblance of free speech. Obviously,
it's better here than it is in Yemen.
But that doesn't mean I'm going to fillet the politicians or, you know, tell them that they're the best country in the world and try to inflate their egos any more so than they already are.
Well, it's ludicrous to think that you're going to have progress in a free republic by saying everything's great here. You don't get progress that way.
Yeah, for sure. Well,
and you're always going to have people standing on the outside saying, oh, you hate the government. Why is it? I really don't understand. You know, this guy Bosch created the
spark plug?
No, not the – he. You know, his name's on a lot of stuff. He created the fuel injector.
Okay.
And it was finally replaced the carburetor. This is just a new technology, a new idea, a better way of doing things. Nobody came out and said, you hate cars! Look, I just want to do things better. I believe this country is better when it treats people, treats people like adults. It increases human freedom. Mm. That's all I'm saying. And yes, I do think that this country should not be involved in shouldn't be supporting the dictators and sheiks around the world. I think it's disgusting that a country that fought for its freedom from a king more than 200 years ago, now supports a king in Saudi Arabia and dictators in Yemen. And I think that's disgusting.
Share with us how you feel. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I've gotten critique before, Mark, because, you know, I engage in activism that some people have decided is not worthy of people's time. Like, for instance, there's one critic who's told me that, well, why don't you do some real activism? And he compares me to his daughter. Like, his daughter is in Washington, D.C., and she works with some sort of genocide group or whatever to try to stop genocide and
great
other countries around the world. And the suggestion is that because we're saving people from parking tickets in Keene, New Hampshire, that somehow it's unworthy to do activism like that. That, you know, everything's fine here in the United States. Why don't you focus on other parts of the world? Which, honestly, I'm sorry, I don't think I can have much of an effect on other parts of the world, but I can absolutely have an effect right here where I live. And I can make some people's lives better in doing that. And to me, that's worthwhile.
You gotta do what makes you happy in life. And, you know, why doesn't that guy do something else that I want him to do? Well, because that would be a stupid thing to do.
Yeah.
Live your life for other people, especially trolls on the internet.
No doubt. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Whether it's pigs, secession, Ross Ulbricht, the Silk Road, these are some of the things we've talked about tonight. Or you can bring up what you would like. Toll-free at 855-450-FREE. More coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Chuck Woolery here. You know, I've talked before about Australian Dream, the effective arthritis pain relief cream that doesn't burn, isn't greasy, and has no odor. Now there's new Australian Dream back pain cream with all those great benefits. But this penetrating formula can help relieve your simple back pain. And it's backed by an empty jar guarantee. If you're not satisfied, you can send back the empty jar for a full refund. But I don't think you will, because Australian Dream really works. Don't let back pain ruin your day. Get Australian Dream back pain cream at Walgreens.
Do you ever say, I could care less?
when you really mean the opposite, you mean to say, I couldn't care less. It's a common mistake. You are judged by how you speak, especially if you're looking for work, with so many more applicants than openings now. But even if you're not, avoiding common misstatements will help you make the most of the dozens of conversations and transactions that crowd your daily routine. So whatever you say, don't say whatever as a single word sentence. It's the most annoying expression in the American English language, according to a recent poll. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. But seriously, at the end of the day, you'll want to avoid this scenario, sounding like everyone else. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. Enough time for you. If you dial in right now, we'll get you in at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. Do you like what we're doing here at Free Talk Live? Well, if so, we have something that you can do for us. You go to become an amplifier. AMP stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote AMP. You go to amp.freetalklive.com, and you can sign up there for $5 a month. And thank you to everybody who has taken the time to do this. It only takes a moment to get signed up. And then once that $5 a month is rolling in, you don't even have to think about it unless something happens like your credit card, you know, expires or something. Then you'll probably have to change some information. But for the most part, you don't have to think about it. And that $5 a month comes into us. We invest it into the show so we can get on more great radio stations around the country. We're on over 150 stations today talking about the ideas of freedom. We could be on 300. Just need your assistance. So please go to amp.freetalklive.com. We can get more internet listeners on board with the AMP dollars as well. So again, that's amp.freetalklive.com. One example of some of the stuff that we can do with the AMP dollars is we go to industry conventions a couple times a year, 1 to 2 times a year usually, and schmooze it up with the bigwigs in talk radio. Also, we use some of the money to hire an industry veteran, this guy Skip, who's been with us now for a decade. Coming up,
really?
2015 will be a decade.
Really?
That we've had Skip on with us.
Wow.
Believe it or not. Yeah, he was one of the first buys that we made with the AMP dollars back in the early days, and it's been a great relationship with him, and he helps bring us new radio stations that we otherwise might not really get because he knows people, you know. It helps to know people.
He's also basically a consultant too.
Yeah.
When I have questions, I call him.
Yeah, he's great, and he works cheap too, so you know, we've been able to do that for a long time, and you can help us do more over at amp.freetalklive.com. Wyatt's listening in Tallahassee to WVFT. Hello, Wyatt.
Hey, fellas. You know, I agree with almost all the stuff you guys talk about, but one thing I've never really heard is a synopsis of, I know about the Free State Project, and I've read a little bit about that, but could you guys, and I'll get offline and let you describe it, what's the ideal form of government for the United States in 2014? I mean, we do face a lot of global threats. I've been all over the world fighting fights that don't really make any sense to me, but I do know one thing. Those people propagate hate in the Middle East. They hate us. And I mean, how do you become a free society with a limited government? I mean, how does that, if you're president for a day or you have the ear of our government, how do we establish a a more perfect union. And I appreciate what you're doing, guys, and I'll take your answer offline.
Sure.
All right, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
First off, I think that what goes on in Washington, D.C. is unfixable. But if you want the fiction story of what I would like to see it evolve into, is I basically don't think the federal government has any business doing anything other than regulating disputes between the states. And by regulating, I mean, arbitrating disputes between the states and handling the military. Now, I think that military should be kept within the borders or in the case of the Navy, within close to the borders and that sort of thing. And that the United States government shouldn't be going around the world being the world's policeman. But anything else the federal government does, I'm willing to give them a nod on the interstate system. I think they did a really great job. As far as the interstate system's a great system, but I think that states probably could have come up with this. If basically states are charged with maintaining them anyway, so they just made roads connect and they did that before anyhow. So I don't think they have any business doing anything else. I wouldn't have the federal government do anything but that.
Well, to me, a more perfect union would be the absence of a union. So let's see the dissolution of the union. I see no purpose in having a federal government whatsoever. I mean, I get your points, Mark, but why bother? Why bother with it? The Soviet Union didn't work out. It went away. And so these big mega states, what's the point? It just consolidates power in one place. And
Estonia is a much freer place now that the Soviet Union's gone.
And some of the states there, have had different
and richer
results. There's the former Soviet states. There's a variety of results that have come from how they've chosen to go about things.
Based on how much liberty they allowed their individuals.
It's true. And Estonia is probably arguably the freest and the best of all of those marketplaces.
It's arguably one of the freest and best places to live in the world. And that's 10 years after, it's more than that, within 2 decades after the fall of the Soviet Union.
But I say split it up and let the 50 states go 50 separate ways and let's see what happens out of that. Let's see the various different options and choices and political systems that can arise from that level of being able to choose. Now, certainly, it could be that some of those places will become less free places as a result of that. The argument might be made that Alabama might decide to bring back Jim Crow laws or something, crazy like that. I'm sorry, Alabama, if anybody's listening there. But just giving you an example, so maybe there is an argument that the federal government has in some instances prevented some states from doing some bad things. But overall, the bad from the federal government far outweighs the killings and the destruction of people's lives and the millions of people arrested. The insane war on drugs. I mean, there's just so much. The regulations that have driven businesses out of the United States. There's just so much incalculable damage to our freedom and the economy in the United States that, you can't really figure this out. But I'd rather take the risk, personally, of not having the federal government around and having that extra freedom that would come with that and whatever happens might happen.
Yeah, I think that if you wanted to if you wanted a quick fix, I'd say that you should have 100% of senators and representatives and the president vote to pass a law and only need 50% of them to undo one.
Let's continue here with your calls and thoughts. Nathan is in Texas via Skype. Hello, Nathan.
Hey, fellas. Well, I cooked bacon for the first time today in a long time. And to be honest, that's probably the only thing that prevents me from becoming a vegetarian.
Bacon?
Bacon is a delicious thing.
Delicious bacon. I wanted to ask you, Mark, if you've what's been your experience? I might have missed it before with raising your own pork, and you don't raise chickens, right?
But no, I have nothing to do with chickens.
Did you just tune into the show? Because we spent the bulk of the second hour and most of this hour on that topic, or half of this hour. So we spent basically now an hour and a half on Mark's pigs here tonight. So I don't know if we can really summarize all that has been said.
Ask your question.
In that time frame.
Okay, my question is, would you be interested in trying an experiment? I was thinking what you could do is go to the supermarket or store or whatever there is in Keene and buy some pork shoulder. And, you can use my recipe. I can email you, or just a general sausage recipe, and cook that and then compare that to the sausage that you get from your own pigs.
A pork shoulder is a pretty big meal.
What?
Why don't you buy some bacon? Make it easy.
Yeah, bacon would be a lot easier, but you can tell the difference in the cut and consistency and the smoking.
That's a good point.
So you have done that kind of taste test before, and it's really obvious?
No, he hasn't.
I've had bacon side by side, but it's obvious. You know, my bacon's obvious to me because it's thicker cut, and
you can get thick cut bacon at the store though.
Yeah,
right?
It's just, believe me, Ian, I can tell the difference between my bacon and theirs, and smoking's really important when it comes to bacon too. I will still contend, to my dying breath, that my pork tastes better.
How can we figure this out though? How can we actually do a taste test? Can you get an unsmoked bacon? Is all bacon smoked?
All bacon smoked.
Okay. Hey, Nathan, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. David's in North Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. David.
Carolina, California. So
Northern California?
So sorry about that. Go ahead, sir.
That's okay. When the screener was asking me what I was talking, I didn't even know it was a screener. It was going on and on and on. And he says, no, I'm just a screener. You gave me enough information. Anyways, when you guys were talking about, when... I forgot which jobs, but people hire speed people that are on crank or crack for what kind of. I was working about a week ago moving someone, and these people I never met before, but I was helping them out, and they had a moving company from down near San Francisco, which is about 4 hours south of where I am. And one conversation led to a lot of people that are in the moving business. I don't do it all the time. I help sometime. Are into doing speed, and I assume that's crank or crack. Mm-hmm. And I was so surprised. So that verifies with one you just said that some employees. I think you were talking about construction, weren't you?
The statement I made was I knew somebody who managed a construction crew at one time, and he told me he'd rather have a crackhead on his crew than an alcoholic, because the crackhead would be there at 6 a.m. because he needed a crack fix, and he would be there to go to work while the alcoholic wouldn't. And by the way, speed is not the same thing as crack. Crack is a different form of cocaine. It's a freebase form of cocaine, if I'm not mistaken. And so instead of insufflation, which is, snorting it, crack is smoked. It is free-based. And so not the same thing as speed and or, what was the other term that he used?
Crank.
I believe crank is slang for speed, if I'm not mistaken there. So I hope that clears some of it up. David, we're out of time, but thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. We are out of time for tonight. But, Mark, I don't know if you do have some pictures. Are these your pictures of the pigs on the Free Talk Live Facebook
pigs.
Page? Okay, so
Rand Paul spotted. He's different than all the rest.
FreeTalkLive.com. You can see the piggies when they were smaller. We'll see you online tomorrow or on the air in the meantime. FreeTalkLive.com.
Free Talk Live.
They have to pass a law that all the guns that are currently there have to disappear in a puff of smoke. That's what they have to do.
Oh, wait, you mean the bad guys won't actually give up their firearms when the authorities come around to confiscate them?
It doesn't really matter that they won't give up their firearms because we're going to pass a law.
Oh, because we pass a law, they'll just all disappear.
Right, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Man, it's just amazing how powerful laws are.
Yes.
How just
laws aren't a bunch of dumb crap written on paper. They actually do something. It's really, really stupid.
What will be stupid is if they vote for it.
Yeah.
Taking our
away,
guns.
You know, these criminals with the guns are going to kill people.
Yeah. They already are, apparently.
And if you don't have a weapon of your own, you're just as good as dead. Once the laws go into effect that there shouldn't be any weapons anymore, because then they know that the good people don't have weapons.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, December 12th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.07 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $352. Antiwar.com reports the Syrian civil war has gotten so convoluted and created so many rival factions that sometimes it's hard to know who is fighting against whom at any given time. It also gives rise to conspiracy theories. One of those theories is that the Islamic State and the Assad government are secretly in league, since the two largest factions in Syria rarely clash directly and rather focus on the smaller players. It's not as though they never fight, of course. Syria launched high-profile attacks on the Islamic State's capital of Raqqa earlier this month, and the Islamic State is still bragging about the recent capture of a Syrian airbase in the Raqqa province. And while other rebels grouse about the comparatively little help from the Islamic State against Assad, it was really those rebels who started attacking the Islamic State in the spring, and the Islamic State has turned the tables on them, expanding their territory at the expense of the other rebels. For their part, the Islamic State is presenting the direct fight against Assad as step two, saying they need to consolidate the rebel territories first before they can make a serious run on Assad territory. Similarly, the Assad government is seeing the smaller rebels as easy pickings, with the U.S. airstrikes and internal rebel fightings keeping the Islamic State mostly at bay. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, just hours before a potential government shutdown, the U.S. House of Representatives on Thursday passed a massive $1.1 trillion government spending bill. The funding bill passed with a vote of 219 to 206 with a majority of support from Republicans. Things were in doubt earlier in the day after the House took an unexpected recess around 2 o'clock for 7 hours due to dissent on both sides of the aisle. Many Republicans were incensed that the proposed spending does not include language to defund President Obama's executive action on immigration. Democrats opposed amendments to Wall Street reform language in the bill. Though lawmakers in the House came to an agreement late Thursday, the bill still had to pass the Senate before midnight to avoid a government shutdown. The Senate approved a two-day extension of the current funding levels in order to give itself more time to review and vote on the legislation. In the House, 162 Republicans voted in favor of the bill, 67 rejected it. 57 Democrats supported, while 139 opposed. The spending bill, if signed into law, would fund the government through September, with the exception of the Department of Homeland Security, which runs out of money early next year. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To